This is going to be an extremely heavy news day. Donald Trump was set to come down to the Laredo, Texas border, one of the most dangerous areas on the 2,200-mile border with Mexico. So we sent down Joe Biggs and Josh Owens. And while they're there just shooting a report yesterday evening at about 8 o'clock when it's still daylight, you see about 10 guys swim across the river with huge containers in front of them, huge bundles, drug bundles. And they were able to get in their car, drive over, and film from like 60 yards away on a busy highway, them loading the contraband on and then the smugglers running back into the bushes. Some of the most powerful drug smuggling footage I've ever seen. And there's a lot of it out there. The video, caught on camera, illegal smuggled drugs into Laredo before Trump visit. This is the middle of a major city with 18-wheelers and cars and school buses driving around. Then they had the spotters they recognized casing them last night and early this morning at their hotel. They've got so many spies and operatives. Famous intelligence network with the cartel. So our guys went ahead for security reasons and bugged out. They are almost back, and they will be in studio with us today, both Josh Owens and, of course, Joe Biggs. And Joe Biggs went in to where they reported the ISIS compound a few months ago that made national news. And indeed, there was a bizarre mosque built in the middle of the town. And the FBI then showed up at the airport wanting to debrief the crew and said, we just can't believe that you had the courage to do that. My question is, where's the mainstream media on this? In fact, where's the coverage of our video that's been out since last night? It's nowhere. It's up on Infowars.com. Just like Jakari Jackson and Adan Salazar went down there and to one of our contacts in McAllen with ICE, and they said, just come to this place. You'll see us loading them on buses with vouchers to ship them into the U.S. It took the New York Times 5 months to report on it, and they just admitted matter-of-factly, yeah, we ship the illegals into the country. And then Fox News asked a senior current Border Patrol member about it on TV, and he said, yeah, we complete the smuggling process, but we get hauled in for reprimands and even basically charged with releasing classified info if we tell you we're completing the smuggling process. So there they are, keeping that quasi-secret. And even when Infowars.com does our job and millions of people hear about it here and see it, still the mainstream media won't cover it. So that report from Joe Biggs and that powerful video is coming up in the next segment. We've got Texas governor, just an amazing statesman. I just can't believe we have a governor this good. I mean, he's presidential material. Greg Abbott, basically investigating and looking at criminal indictments of Planned Parenthood for selling baby parts. We've got other governors doing it. Of course, leading this is Rand Paul with the original call for it. So there's leadership, there's statesmanship right there. Rand Paul spearheaded the effort starting last week to defund Planned Parenthood. It's coming up next week in Congress. The GOP is now moving, thanks to the leadership of Rand Paul, Greg Abbott, our listeners, and others. Drudge Report covering it, to defund Planned Parenthood. How does the establishment respond? MSNBC, Salon, Media Matters, they are now saying the Planned Parenthood video is a hoax. You heard me right, and it's not real. Then they go on to admit it's real, but say our interpretation's a hoax. And then get this, they say Margaret Sanger was not racist. And I guess Hitler loved Jews too, right? Conspiracy theorists have hijacked the GOP. What happens when Trump, Cruz, and Carson start following Alex Jones' lead? And then they go in there and say, there's no Planned Parenthood, baby part sales, and Margaret Sanger's good. We've definitely got the establishment upset and worried. We are aware of their criminal operations. We are aware of their philosophy. We are aware of their battle plans. And we're here blowing their operation wide open worldwide. If the people simply begin to research our claims, discover they're true, discover it's even more complex and worse than we're saying, and then transmit that warning to others, we can cause a chain reaction of global awakening that will bring down the technocrats' plan for a one-world eugenics-based government. Thank you for joining us on this Thursday, the 23rd day already of July 2015. Coming up, we have an amazing author and researcher, Anthony Esselin, author of 10 Ways to Destroy the Imagination of Your Child, Life Under Compulsion. And it breaks down the scientific program to destroy your children's minds and to make them unthinking, mindless trendies that just repeat whatever they're told and can change their worldviews on a day-to-day basis. Rudderless, soulless, mindless slaves. He'll be joining us for about 40 minutes of the third hour. We are going to be having Joe Biggs and Josh Owens in studio as soon as they get back from the Texas-Mexico border on the Rio Grande, where yesterday evening, before dark, they got HD footage of illegals swimming across with bundles of what is clearly drugs, loading them into a truck, and then driving off on a busy highway. We even got the license number and are giving it to the, quote, authorities as we speak. And the issue here is the border is wide open, but they've got the Border Patrol on duties upwards to 100 miles inland searching citizens' cars. Meanwhile, the big banks are caught laundering with drug money. That powerful report with Joe Biggs' intro is coming up here in just a few minutes. Donald Trump was supposed to show up down there, but then canceled his visit last night at 11:30. We certainly had some questions for him. Also, we're going to hand him a WorldNet Daily research article and some other proofs that McCain actually was a trustee at the Hanoi Hilton, and a lot of POWs said he was a traitor during their 5 years of captivity so that he could truly strike back at McCain and not give a half-baked response that being shot down and being a prisoner doesn't make you a hero. I don't know. In most cases, getting shot down and being tortured for 5 years makes you pretty heroic. And again, that's my issue with Trump. Is he super smart, and does he say stuff like this to derail himself on purpose? But he's standing by what he said, and people are standing by him because folks are tired of double talk, so I certainly like that. And Trump now has told Anderson Cooper that people don't trust you and the mainstream media, and that's absolutely the type of talk folks want to hear. MSNBC is stunned by Clinton's upside-down poll numbers. In fact, in battleground states, every Republican frontrunner is between 10 and 15 points ahead of her. Trump's 15, Rand Paul's 10. It's just amazing that this is going on. And I like Rand Paul. He's been on the show for 20 years. He is a listener. The media makes a big deal out of that. He should be running towards that, not away from it. And he's not running away from it. Last time Senator Paul was on, I got a call, and they said, the senator wants to come on. He said he'd come on your show. And he came on because the media was making a big deal out of the fact that he's been coming on the show since he was campaigning for his dad for Congress 20 years ago. Quite frankly, Rand Paul coming on the show doesn't boost our ratings. I can cover the info. That's what matters. I'm not begging to get any of these politicians on the show. I don't even try to get him on or make an issue out of it. Because they do spin it, they do twist it, and it, at some levels might hurt him. But I only raise this issue because I know he's got people in his office who are basically rhinos. And they are advising him to go to the center, which is the opposite. When the left is off in totalitarian la-la land at warp speed, acting like a cult, you don't moderate towards them. You stand on the Constitution and Bill of Rights, and you point out that they're a bunch of insane criminals, which he's doing to a certain extent. But stunts like taking a chainsaw to the tax code, you don't need to do that. You need to just say, I'm going to abolish the IRS, and we do have a lot of criminals pouring into the country, and Donald Trump's right. The problem is he's given so much money to Democrats, I don't trust him. That's what Rand Paul should be doing, not saying he disagrees with Donald Trump's statements, but actually saying it in a more statesmanlike way. And look, I only say this because I know this goes directly to the senator. I know he routinely listens to the show. And it just, if he wants to be president, I know he's a gentleman. And I know that he's a good guy and a classy guy. He needs to get aggressive. That's, I mean, his dad, that was my problem with his dad, is he was just not aggressive enough. And I, you know, I love Ron Paul. It's just the political pundits are constantly telling people to be milquetoast, to be nice, to compromise. That's how the country got in the position we're in right now. The Social Security Administration is going to be commanded now by the VA, the FBI, and the ATF with some secret formula like the no-fly list to take Social Security recipients' guns. This has been announced. The FBI memo is public. It's in the LA Times. We've got a full-on mega alert. And the good news is, this is the good part about the Republicans. They are talking about having hearings. They're talking about cutting funding. They're saying, Social Security, do not do this. Well, we need more than that. We need to have people resigning over an attempt outside of law to do something like this. It is unprecedented. Let me just read to you some of the headlines. Texas governor calls for expanded probe of Planned Parenthood in wake of new video. Rand Paul spearheads effort to defund Planned Parenthood. That's bold. That's wonderful. I love the senator. I'm just saying go further. He's the only one saying abolish the Patriot Act. Only one saying get rid of foreign funding. Only one saying, you know, we shouldn't have funded ISIS. GOP moves to defund Planned Parenthood. See, following his lead. Kansas and Missouri call for investigation of Planned Parenthood among questions about aborted fetuses being sold. And then how does White House talking point repeater station Shalon put it?
Conspiracy theorists have hijacked the GOP. What happens when Trump, Cruz, and Carson start following Alex Jones's lead?
And they go on to say it's a hoax, there is no Planned Parenthood, and that Margaret Sanger basically loved black people. I mean, this Bob Seska is like a dark satire comedy writer. I mean, next he's going to say the moon is made out of cheese. I mean, Margaret Sanger got awards from Hitler, gave awards from Hitler. Her letters in her own hand are public at major universities saying, we can't let the blacks know we want to exterminate the weeds. We got to hire all the black leaders and call ourselves liberal. And then you sit there saying she's a wonderful feminist. I mean, you people are sick. You really are sick. Planned Parenthood admits those videos are real and claims it doesn't represent them. And you don't care. You prey on your cult readers who would drink cyanide Kool-Aid if they were ordered to and tell them that we're liars. I mean, you people are sick. You're sick. This is the publication calling for me to be arrested or shut off the air. They're totalitarians. Here's another one. We have video of this. I'm going to play it later. Liberal tolerance. Transgender threatens to put conservative pundit in the hospital on live TV. And it's like a big old giant guy with a blonde wig on. It's like Police Academy where they got beards and their own stakeouts. And it's like, you wouldn't hit a woman, would you? And they punch you in the face. And I'd say, step outside. I don't care if you're wearing a wig. You're like probably outweighs him by about 50 pounds, big old man dressed up like a woman saying, I'm going to put you in the hospital. I better get an ambulance. And then it got praised all over the left saying, awesome. I mean, this is a violent cult of miscreants. Here's another one. Swedish far right, close quote, plans gay pride parade through Muslim areas. Leftists and gay rights groups decry the parade as racist. I mean, what a cult, man. As long as it's completely anti-freedom, anti-Western, they will endorse totalitarianism and they will call it liberal. This is a group of sick freaks. Simply insane. U.S. decides against publicly blaming China for data hack. It's admitted that China did it and grabbed 21 million dossiers on federal employees. You talk about the holy grail of penetrating U.S. networks. Which it doesn't even matter. I mean, our government's already penetrated by the globalists and run by the globalists that have just sold us out. But it just shows how they're even inept at protecting their own criminal enterprise. And that's the good news. You know, this elite has a lot of chutzpah, a lot of bravado, a lot of arrogance, a lot of pride, a lot of hubris, a lot of delusions of grandeur, of invincibility. But that's all you got. I mean, 50 years ago when they built nuclear reactors, they hardly ever blew up. 30 years ago, they kept them running pretty safe, and people cared when they had a problem. Now they're just melting down, blowing up, leaking just 90-plus percent of them, and the elite doesn't even care. It's just a bunch of delusional people with your mistresses playing golf all day while you start war with Russia and the military falls apart thinking you're invincible. And you think because, you know, you tell us to put our five-year-old boys in dresses and teach them how to give fellatio that, you know, you're invincible and we're going to follow your orders. No. People are waking up to you and it's over. We understand what you're doing. When we come back, Joe Biggs reports from the border. They're driving on their way about an hour away from Austin. They'll be joining us in the last 30 minutes of the transmission. Joe Biggs and Josh Owens will both be in studio with us coming up in the last 30 minutes of the broadcast today. Extremely powerful footage is up on Infowars.com. Shot from what looks like about 60 yards away. Caught on camera, illegal smuggled drugs into the U.S., into Laredo before Trump visit. Shock video validates Trump's assertion on Mexicans bringing drugs into America. Paul Watson says validates it. Trump simply said organized crime cartels are pouring in. Mexico's collapsed. The main business is the drug trade. And now we've got kidnapping and just all these other Latin American crime wave type things coming here. And that's why South America is so scary, folks. You get kidnapped, you get killed. It's just very scary in many areas. And that's what's being exported here now. Doesn't mean everybody's like that, but the crime wave is real. And they sit there and go, no, it's a hoax. No one's a criminal. And our own government released 36,000 aggravated felons in the last 12 months, and they won't even pick up people who've been deported five times and have committed seven felonies. So the guy goes out in San Francisco and just shoots some 30-year-old woman and for fun. This is crazy. There have been 611,000 crimes committed by illegals just in Texas in the last few years. 2.5 million illegal immigrants flooded U.S. during Obama administration, many of them hardened criminals because you can get away with it up here. And Joe Biggs and Josh Owens were there shooting a report at the river, the Rio Grande, when they saw a bunch of men swimming across pushing big packages in front of them. They caught mules on tape. Here's the footage for radio listeners. Go to Infowars.com, see the video, see the report, and email it to your friends and family. Because just because the dinosaur media is going to try to cover this up doesn't mean they can stop you. You have the power. So spread this info. Here it is.
Joe Biggs here with Infowars.com. Now, you might be asking yourself as to why I'm sitting in front of this random white backdrop. That's because right now, Josh Owens and I are currently on the run from a cartel. Now, we got very, very golden footage, the kind of footage that most reporters would wait their entire life in hopes to get and probably would never, ever get a chance. We actually witnessed a drug smuggling operation from Mexico into the U.S. Now, this is intense. We were seen by spotters. They walked up. They got pictures of our license plate. They got pictures of me. And that's why we're doing this. This is not a joke. We had to take our license plate off our vehicle. We had to hide the vehicle. And now we are in hiding. And we're hoping we can get this footage out to you guys so you can see. Because the reason we came out here was to talk about Donald Trump, because he's coming out here to visit Laredo. And one of the things he wanted to talk about was how our borders are so wide open. Now we have proof for the American people to show you just how wide open the borders are. To show you how easy it is for a large amount of drugs to come across the Rio Grande River and into the back of a vehicle to speed away into the unknown. This is a real problem, and now we're going to take a look at that footage. As you can see, we're sitting on the side of the border right here, the Rio Grande Valley, or the Rio Grande River, I should say, in Laredo, Texas. There are people coming over in rafts across the border over to the U.S. side. This is actually happening right now. We just saw this. Cameraman Joshua Owen saw it over my shoulder as we were just reporting on Donald Trump coming in to talk about the unsecured border. This is breaking news. Right here, InfoWars catches it.
All right, I'm getting it. Don't put your hand up.
We just caught these guys coming across the border. They're jumping in. They just jumped in rafts. They're coming over. 1, 2, 3, 4. They have big satchels. They're driving away in this. That was a red Ford Explorer, right?
Yeah.
And this is going on up and down the border. I saw similar things and got footage of it, though it wasn't as up close in Big Bend. And the Border Patrol is 75 miles away, in that case, searching people's vehicles, citizens. And then they had the park rangers riding college kids, as if they're kids, adults, and a bunch of UT lawyer alumni who were out throwing a football to each other and had like little coolers with a couple Coors Lights in them. They were writing them tickets and threatening them and getting real aggressive when they're just Americans out drinking a couple beers. Meanwhile, the illegals were pouring across selling drugs to people that were coming to the border to buy them as retail purchasers right there in front of me. This, of course, was probably $100 million or $50 million, who knows,
we're on the march,
of product we just videoed. Empire. I talk a lot about the Manhattan Project. In fact, will you guys give me a printup from the encyclopedia on that? To talk about a program that in today's dollars cost over $1 trillion. It was tens of billions back at the time. And they kept it secret for 4 years, with more than 100,000 people working directly on the project with pretty much full knowledge, with hundreds of thousands of others having partial knowledge. Now, the eugenics global takeover, the New World Order takeover, is conservatively about 100 times bigger than the Manhattan Project. Because within it, you have the geoengineering project that's bigger than the Manhattan Project and kept secret. You've got all these other projects, the soft kill projects, the fluoride in the water, the GMO designed to brain damage and cause infertility, the chemicals added to the plastics. And then the globalists even write books admitting they're doing it. And it comes out in ABC News, secret meeting at Einstein University with the Rockefellers and royalty on how to reduce population. And then we go read the minutes of subdirectorates that are public, and they're admitting the plan. And I've talked about it. They tried to bring my dad into this Manhattan Project when he was a junior in high school. They tested 150 of the highest test score people. He would spend a lot of his high school time that year when he was a junior and senior at University of Texas, being inducted into their Plan 2 program. And he got called aside by the director of the program. Six of them took him into his office for coffee. This is when they were seniors. He entered it when he was a junior. And he told him. And by the way, my dad remained friends with this guy. And when I was a kid, and we'd come down to Austin to visit my grandparents, my mom's parents lived here, they sometimes would break away and, you know, go say hi to him at his house. And that was Professor Speer, who was from Germany but was Jewish, head of the botany department. And he called my dad in with five other people and said, "You are, from our tests, the smartest people, wide spectrum in Texas." He was obsessed with breeding plants and breeding moths and all this other stuff. And he said, "We'd like to induct you guys into a eugenics program to get you seated in place in governmental positions." And it is eugenics. It's not like the Nazi eugenics. It's a larger plan across the board for the good. And my dad never became a part of it. And the reason I raise that here, before I get into all this other news, is the border being wide open is now proven to be public, that the government pays to ship the illegals in and ships into Democratic-controlled bases, large churches and other facilities, to then be given a driver's license and able to vote, and then to be put on welfare to bring the country down. And we broke it. It's been proven. It's a fact. They could keep that secret for a year. It took us a year to discover it. And it was only because the Border Patrol called us. This was going on for a year. Now it's 2 years. completely open, completely illegal, gigantic program, shipping millions in, 40-something thousand pairs of 6X underwear. I mean, that's the folks they're shipping in from Latin America, is the total welfare heads where those countries are collapsing, not the hardworking folks we've gotten in the past. How could they keep that secret? How do they keep it secret that they've been funding ISIS and Al-Qaeda for 5 years against Syria, Libya, and Egypt? And now it's come out in Congress. They just do it. How do they keep it secret that they work with Saudi Arabia to carry out 9/11? And now it's starting to come out. So all of this is like a Manhattan Project. The whole New World Order operates that way, using our resources, our money. I was on Jenny McCarthy's syndicated radio show this morning. I'm going to get her to come on ours. And she was like, no, that makes a lot of sense. I understand it. And we were going over the soft kill documents and the plan, how they don't want you to just, you know, they give you a shot and you die in an hour. That becomes too obvious. They give you a shot and then you die of cancer 10 years later. Everyone I know has a close friend who's 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, who's dying of cancer. I have two close friends who their best friends are dying, both women, age 30 and 36, right now. Super healthy people, yoga teachers, you name it. Cancer rates in children, depending on the cancer, but on average are up more than 10,000% since 1955. Look it up. Lung cancer in women is up sevenfold, even though smoking has declined over the last 30 years in women and men. We're being murdered. They're spraying aluminum salts and barium and everything else you can imagine added to the jet fuel. It's partially declassified to giant Department of Energy program. NASA admits the Earth is now 30% darker because of it, the persistent contrails. That's another Manhattan Project. They estimate half the public by 2025 in England will have cancer. We're being murdered by a globalist eugenics Manhattan Project. And I'm going to say it again before I get to the news, because it's all that matters at the end of the day. And I'm going to go back into the history books and actually do some reports on this. It came out in the Nuremberg trial, the plan that the Germans had working with the UK and working with what they saw as Aryan populations to resettle. But they were going to be liberators to Africa, Latin America, Asia. They were going to have the Japanese as the super race over the Asians, and they were going to allow them to operate. They believed the Japanese were smart enough to be able to be part of the conspiracy, and the emperor was a big eugenicist. That's all well known of Japan. And they were going to take over, advertise that they were there to help, keep leaders of the group, of whatever racial group they were taking over in, you know, up front, just like Margaret Sanger did, buying off the black leaders. And that they would then put poison in the water and in the food to slowly debilitate and dumb the public down over several generations, then phasing everyone out. And that's what we're under. We're being murdered. Do you understand that? I mean, you think we tell you 10 years ago that Planned Parenthood sells baby parts? That had come out in lawsuits then. Now it's all admitted. And so I just want to warn everybody over at these White House-run outfits who make jokes at Media Matters and make jokes at Salon and make jokes at Raw Story and make jokes over at MSNBC. Listen, it's all going to come out. And people are going to remember those of you that went along with this. And you're going to be held accountable at Nuremberg-style trials. This isn't funny. So you go ahead and try to indict the governor, try to indict the attorney general in Texas because they're investigating Planned Parenthood and because they're investigating the carbon tax and because they're investigating the open border. You go ahead and try to indict me because I know they got me getting followed around. You go ahead and pull whatever you're going to pull. We're not on the side that chops up babies and sells their organs. Got it? So you've picked your side. That's good. But those people out there that read your publications and watch your television shows that are being preyed on need to understand you're working under some very, very evil people. And you might want to think twice about what you're part of. Because they put fluoride in everybody's water. They try to force inoculations on everybody, including their servants. And it's come out that in the U.S. and in Europe and in China and Japan, the elites get clean, good, engineered, true vaccines that have side effects but really can protect you. You try to misrepresent that we're against the science of inoculation. That's not what's being said here. You put out poisonous bilge. And you're basically taking part in this whole situation when you defend it. Guys, they've got a warehouse door open over there into my studio. They don't have both doors sealed. It sounds like a freight train's wrecking in there. Can we get those shut? Thank you. Now, continuing here, ladies and gentlemen, we have a decision to make. And now the federal government is announcing they're going to track adults that are unvaccinated and start trying to basically force you to take shots and use the IRS as the enforcement mechanism, just as they're now doing in Australia. This is a global plan. And believe me, being trendy, wearing different color socks that don't match, going to a gay pride parade and supporting Caitlyn Jenner, I know you think is a force field that makes you morally super intellectual and super smart. But I'm going to try to explain to you that's all just pop diversions while the real world goes on to have us fighting with each other. And you're drinking poison water. You're being injected with deadly cancer viruses. You're being fed GMO that kills the guinea pigs that eat it. You're being fed corn that kills the pigs that eat it. And so when you get cancer at 40, or your wife or husband does, or your son or daughter does, or when you know, everybody in your family history had healthy kids, but you have two kids, and both of them, one of them's brain damaged, and the other one's got deformities, just understand you were hit and hit hard, and you deserve to know who killed you. You see, the 223 or 556 bullet was developed to not kill statistically on average, but to wound, because they found that that would sap enemy resources, having to take care of a person that was wounded by a high velocity round that goes 2,300 feet per second that tends to break up inside the body, because the Geneva Convention banned hollow point bullets. The Pentagon got around it by creating a fragmentation full metal jacket round that would get around the Geneva Convention. Now, why do I bring that up? Because that's what autism is. That's what neurological disorders skyrocketing are. It's not just the background radiation threefold what it was in 1945 in the Northern Hemisphere. It's not just the chemicals and the glyphosates in the water. It's not just the plastic linings. It's not just the vaccines. It's all of it together, and they're just exacerbating it to make it as horrible as they can. So remember, you're laughing now. You won't be laughing later. So just remember when you're burying your small child who dies from cancer or who dies from having violent seizures every hour. Just remember when you take your 18-month-old in and get that third round of shots and they have a convulsion in the car and then they never talk again, that I warned you and it wasn't funny. It's not funny for Jenny McCarthy. She said, I don't know what's going on, but there was one in 25,000 30 years ago with autism, and now it's one in 58, and it's set to be one in 10 by 2025, and then one in 5, and then one in 3, until suddenly nobody can talk, and everyone's drooling, and the average person is throwing feces up against the wall, and then no one's asking, what's going on? Why is this happening? Because there's a giant globalist program poisoning the food and water by design. Read John P. Holdren, the White House science czar's own book, written 40 years ago. 41 years ago now, in 1974, with Paul Ehrlich. And again, I've got hundreds of incredible articles, important stuff to cover. I've got a mother saying the murder by an illegal alien of her son was a 9/11 attack for their family. We've got woman who died in Texas jail cell mentioned previous suicide attempts. We've got commodities collapse just before last stock market crash. So guess what's happening right now? We're going to go over that. It's all coming up today. But before I go any further, I'm going to fund this operation right now. It is such an honor to be your host, such an honor to be able to be independent, such an honor to be able to put up a defense of liberty. You see the White House run publications every day screaming in anger, now calling for us to be shut down and shut up. Open totalitarianism, because we are just beating them over the head with the truth. And it's not just InfoWars, but InfoWars is another key platform to put out the Planned Parenthood videos and then to put it into context. That's where we're really dangerous to the establishment, is we show how it connects into the larger plan. I mean, they thought you were dumb. They thought you'd never wake up to geoengineering. They thought you'd never wake up to soft kill in the food chain. They thought you'd never wake up to what carbon taxes really were. They thought you'd never wake up to radical Islam being funded by criminals in the Western intelligence agencies as a pretext to take over. They never thought you'd wake up to Cloward and Piven or Agenda 21. They thought you'd never get it because it was so horrifying. But now people get it, and they don't care what the mainstream media says or how much they laugh at us or when they come out and say there is no Planned Parenthood video. None of it's real. It's a hoax. And Margaret Sanger loved black people. That's what they're in the news today saying. Good. Lie more. Continue to spew your bull. Tell people the sky is red. Conspiracy theorists, that means think for yourself, have hijacked the GOP. What happens when Trump, Cruz, and Carson start following Alex Jones's lead? And that is our greatest victory, is that we've changed the talking points from the rhino neocon folks that used to have talk radio hosts say there's no world government, no plan for anything, no plan for a carbon tax. The Federal Reserve's not private. The CFR loves you. Do you hear any Republican host talk like that now? No, they sound like me. And they will get more and more hardcore. So that's my ultimate victory. And your ultimate victory is that we are changing the course of the debate and they can't stand it. You're not in charge lecturing us, MSNBC. You go shoot your kids up with vaccines. Oh, they don't. You talk to attorney generals of states, you talk to high-level media people, they laugh and go, of course I don't give my kids shots. Alex, you have a good one. Half the time they go, hey, I'm just doing my job. We don't hate you. Just, Alex, come on. I mean, I've had police chiefs, governors, you name it, just go, listen, I know this stuff's true, but man, I can't believe you're still alive. You got to watch it. What do I do? Let me tell you, the thinking people know what's really going on. So bottom line, we got free shipping in the month of July. We got a new product, Deep Cleanse, that's out. That's just the super cleanser for the whole body. X2 will sell out. I've been thinking it would sell out a few days ago, but it's almost sold out now. The best nation iodine out there. Dr. Group's coming in studio later. It's being bought up. The deep earth crystals for industrial usage at record levels. Governments are buying up the other types of iodine as well. He'll be breaking that down. That's available at InfoWarsLife.com. We now have the knockout that doesn't just have valerian root or things like that in it, or the melatonin. It's got valerian root, melatonin, L-theanine, L-tryptophan, chamomile flower extract, and lemon balm leaf extract, hops flower extract, so much more. And it's the most powerful natural sleeping aid I've ever seen, and it's $19.95 at InfoWarsLife.com. Leading competitors are like $45. We were just talking about the fact that when I'm on the road, sometimes with just natural light via video Skype, I do a lot better shows, more focused, more eloquent. And it's because when I'm in here 3-4 hours under these LED lights, because they're a lot safer and won't burn the building down, it is like being interrogated. And it's exhausting. And I've thought about the fact that I need to start wearing sunglasses during the breaks. So that's something I'm going to do. We got great lighting people. We need to get an expert in here and figure out how to turn the cameras up and the lights down or something, because it is like being flamethrowed. And it's part of my irritability. A lot of issues I found are being under the hot lights. Gets a little bit old. I'm not complaining. I'm just talking about part of the experience of being a radio slash TV host. Nobody does 3 hours of live TV teleprompter free. Well, they've got big round tables of folks and, you know, constantly are going to video clips because they don't have content from their heart. It's a bunch of prepackaged teleprompter written garbage. That's one reason this broadcast is so popular, is that we just break it down from the heart, but also from a historical perspective. And that's why it's so essential that folks realize there's a move to restrict free speech in this country. Don't take it for granted. Use your free speech while we've still got it, and fight for free speech as well. Now, coming up the next hour, I'm going to get into the move to disarm retirees. The Republicans are finally moving to try to block the administration doing it, but there needs to be repercussions for even the attempt, which hasn't been stopped yet, but I mean, the big gun assault is here, and that's what LaPierre has said, it's what Ted Nugent said, it's what Gun Owners of America has said, it's what Professor Lott has said, that the next attack is coming. Well, that was a few months ago, it's here. And again, take advantage of InfoWarsStore.com and the hundreds and hundreds of high-quality products. Take advantage of the nutraceuticals. Take advantage of everything that's available. And know that you are essential to this operation, whether it's spreading the word about it or taking action or calling Congress or getting involved politically, locally, and helping finance the Liberty Movement. That is so essential. You're not just a part of it. You're at the heart of it. So again, I salute you all and thank you for your help. Here is some of the chilling testimony from CNS News, from C-SPAN. Mother says her son, murdered by illegal alien, was our family's 9/11 attack by a foreign invader. Laura Wilkerson, a former mother whose 18-year-old son, Joshua, was murdered by an illegal alien in 2010, passionately appealed to Congress. Let's go to that clip.
This was our family's 9/11 terrorist attack by a foreign invader, whether you want to recognize it or whether you do not. This government continues to fail or even recognize that we have an issue. Americans are dying daily at the hands of criminals that we don't even know are here. You're officially notified today there's a problem when this happens. You can't deny it any longer. You cannot stand by and ignore our families, our American families. You're elected by Americans, not any other country. You should be for Americans. If you want to sit quietly on the sidelines, you've thrown your hat into the ring already. Your silence speaks volumes. You're either for Americans or you're not. I will not give up control another one of my children so that a foreign person can have a nicer life. I'm not going to do it. You don't understand the pain. It's so deep in a soul, in the place that you don't even recognize you have.
We're going to go to break. There aren't words to describe. I'm going to come back and play the full clip. It's very, very powerful. Mexico is collapsing. So are these other countries. And there is a crime wave. And they act like it's hospitality to be robbed and killed. And that we should be honored to be murdered because we're evil America.
Thank you for listening.
It's just sick. It's sick. And then the globalists just want to... New article up on InfoWars.com. MTV ramps up race baiting with new show targeting white people. Microaggressions. If you like black culture, you're racist. If you don't like black culture, you're also racist. Really, what is black culture? What MTV says it is? Gangster rap? CIA written to destroy the entire human race? I mean, what they've sold as black culture is weaponized worldwide. It's weaponized. And now, if you don't like gangster rap, you're racist. If you do like it, you're racist. MTV is continuing its crusade to mainstream tubular social justice warrior insanity with a new video that targets white people for racial microaggressions directed against people of color. Awful things such as saying you like black culture. That's what they say at the universities, that if you're friendly or basically say hi to someone, it shows you're evil. And it's just been turning into mentally ill basket cases. And in the show are all these white kids going and young adults going, I don't know how to prove I'm not. I'll do whatever you say. And the government's like, turn the guns in, support Obamacare, do exactly as we say, and we won't call you racist. Meanwhile, Salon says there's no Planned Parenthood killing babies and selling their body parts. Alex Jones is a liar. And Margaret Sanger loved black people. And next, I guess they'll say Hitler. didn't wear military uniforms, and Bush didn't have a speech impediment. I mean, it's just a whole nother level of just bravado, just con artists just doubling down to intimidate the public and say, I'm going to condescend to you. I'm going to lecture you. You're going to do what I say. We're going to let Mexico, with 100,000 plus dead in the last decade that we know of, just pour across and fail and have serial killers running around and drunk driving and murder and just let people vote and be above the law. If you don't accept it, you're racist. It's just crazy town. Let's go to this video of the mother talking about what happened to her son on C-SPAN. It's extremely powerful. Here it is.
This was our family's 911 terrorist attack by a foreign invader, whether you want to recognize it or whether you do not. This government continues to fail or even recognize that we have an issue. Americans are dying daily at the hands of criminals that we don't even know are here. You're officially notified today there's a problem when this happens. You can't deny it any longer. You cannot stand by and ignore our families, our American families. You're elected by Americans, not any other country. You should be for Americans. If you want to sit quietly on the sidelines, you've thrown your hat into the ring. Already, your silence speaks volumes. You're either for Americans or you're not. I will not give up control another one of my children so that a foreign person can have a nicer life. I'm not going to do it. You don't understand the pain. It's so deep in a soul, in the place that you don't even recognize you have. There aren't words to describe the pain to someone who has not gone through it. I'm not giving up another kid. Sanctuary city policies scream to the criminal element of all of illegals in this country. There is a criminal element. It screams to them, come to our town, USA. We'll protect you from our terrible policemen. We'll protect you from these tough American laws that you, because you had a hard life, are not able to go through the same motions that an American is. They're buying into that fact. It's going to take another life lost by a senator, a congressman, the president, even another of today's heroes, someone from Hollywood, before someone in a position moves on this. I urge you, you're in a position to do something about this for Americans. I thank you to Mr. Trump for getting a message out about the nation in 2 minutes that for 4.5 years solidly.
All right, we're going to break. That's Laura Wilkerson, whose son was killed. We'll be back. I'm Alex Jones. Tons of news straight ahead. Coming up in the next hour, Joe Biggs and Josh Owens will both be in studio with us. They went down to the border yesterday to cover Donald Trump, who canceled his visit. And we're right there on the Rio Grande and saw a bunch of people swimming across with big packages. Drug mules clearly pull up, load up the car, busy highway. And this is just going on constantly down there. But when the cops pull you over, they want to search your car looking for some marijuana. The big banks are laundering the drug money on record. That video is up on Infowars.com. Also, MI5, British defense sources say ISIS will bomb football games with drones. Armed Marine vet standing guard outside recruiting center told to leave or he'll be arrested. BizPak review today. We told you 2 days ago, a caller called in and said that he'd talked to recruiting centers and that it had come down to start calling the police on people that are even at legal strip malls standing out there guard to have the owner of the company, the owner of the property call and have them kicked off for trespassing and to press charges. Not to just say get out of here, but we want prosecution. So that's your criminal government. They don't want the message sent that armed citizens are the answer to terrorism. So that's now confirmed up on Infowars.com from BizPak Review. Seattle's nanny state is deputizing trash men as secret police to snoop through your garbage. Told you about that years ago. It's now on. They've also banned single-family homes under Agenda 21. That's what it does under the UN Treaty. We know exactly what will be done because other countries have already implemented, like Australia. I mean, we know exactly what's going to happen. And then we hold stuff back and people go, where is it? Where is it? Where's the tracker box in my car to tax it by the mile? Well, it started in 6 states this year through the federal pilot program. And you're like, okay, that came true. What about the other stuff? It's all coming true. We're like battling to keep the gates from collapsing. They're on fire. The hordes of globalist tyranny are about to pour in. If you're an unborn baby, you're already getting chopped up and having your organs sold. It's a depression. If you are out of work, it's a recession if your neighbor is. It's the same thing. People have perception problems. The world is collapsing. The world is going into staged revolution. Soros is funding the collapse of at least 5 countries currently. The new Cold War has started. U.S. troops are battling as advisors, Russian soldiers in eastern Ukraine right now in the Crimea. Our government is funding proxy armies of Al-Qaeda under the name ISIS to take over. I mean, it's epic, but we sit here in what's left of the West with our cushy jobs, and even if you're poor, you're better off than most people in the world, and folks don't know how good they've got it. And we're beat over the head by political correctness, and now we have the model of abusing the veterans. Obamacare's based off VA abuse and rationing care, and computers saying what care you get, and the Watson computer controlling it all so humans can write you off and claim they're not guilty. Now they're going to use that system of the VA on all retirees are to be looked at by computers, and one criteria is taking an automatic transfer of your Social Security check and having your bills on auto pay. They deem that you now are inept and that you now can be found to be incompetent. They've already disarmed over 1 million veterans in the last decade, and now they're coming. And I saw this a week and a half ago in the Daily Caller. Couldn't hardly believe it. They had the FBI memo saying, prepare to do this. And then now it's been in the LA Times endorsing it last Sunday. And so now Republicans threaten to block Obama administration latest gun control move. Republicans send letter urging Social Security to abandon the plan. How about they're hauled up and whoever called for it is fired? And how about the president's call before Congress and told, you stop taking guns outside of law. The 68 Gun Control Act, it's unconstitutional and been found to be unconstitutional by D.C. versus Heller, but still it doesn't matter. You are not going to keep acting like an emperor. But the very same Republicans can't have their cake and eat it too. They don't want him to act as a dictator on one issue, but they do on the border, they do on power plants, they do let him do it on Obamacare. They let him do it on so many other issues. TPP. Just incredible. Guantanamo Bay, a closure plan in final stages. It's been in that for 7 years. That's just a public camp to show the public. It's a laboratory research facility. They admit that, run by the CIA. The real ghost sites are all over the world. And U.S. citizens are in them. IRS encrypts an entire CD of documents in response to FOIA request on their persecution of the American people. Tech dirt breaks down so they can follow the FOIA, but then no one can decode it. Trump supporters stand by their man in presidential race. Polls show he's just as popular as he's ever been after they misconstrue what he has to say about the traitor McCain. Trump to Anderson Cooper, again during an interview, says the people don't trust you and the media, and that's absolutely true. MSNBC, and I want to play this clip, is stunned by Clinton's upside-down poll numbers. A Morning Joe panel on MSNBC found it difficult to accept that Hillary Clinton is unpopular and her poll numbers are upside down in crucial swing states. Well, I mean, no one wants Hillary Clinton or Jeb Bush and this Game of Thrones where they pass this crown back and forth between these two royal dynasties. Here's that clip.
Hillary is upside down by 23 in Iowa. She is upside down by 9 in Virginia, which she has to win. She is upside down by 23 in Colorado. And Mika, I think we just in that one snapshot has shown, and I'm sure Jeb Bush's isn't much better, why somebody out of, I was going to say left field, he's not left field or right field, why somebody like Donald Trump attacking politicians is actually getting support.
Oh, my gosh, it's incredible. The people don't buy into it. Coming up, U.S. decides against publicly blaming China for the biggest data breach of national security information ever. We're going to get more into those drones they say are going to be attacking. Scientists warn the world to think twice before replying to alien signals from outer space. Liberal tolerance, transgender, threatens to put conservative pundit in the hospital and is praised. We're going to get into all of this and more today. But Dr. Edward Grupp, patriot, Army special ops veteran, anti-New World Order expert, one of the biggest supplement formulators in the country, very successful. I was on Jenny McCarthy's show today, and you were pointing out in her book she wrote about your Oxy powder a decade ago. The point is, he's a pretty important guy for folks that don't know about supplement formulation. He's teamed up with Infowars.com to help us come out with our flagship products. He manufactures about a third of our products. The other two big labs we use, he helps look over the ingredients and helps look over the testing to advise us. He's a great consultant. But don't worry, I'm not going to infomercial towards the end of this hour to fund our operation with some new products we're going to be announcing today. He's here to cover the waterfront on huge breaking health news and to give us his take on the state of the world. But before we go there, Dr. Grupp, what do you make of the Planned Parenthood videos where their director, their national head of their board of directors, says, I want to get a better price on this. I want to buy a Lamborghini, and ghoulishly haggling. And then they have White House groups, Media Matters, and others come out and say that I'm lying, that this video isn't even real when Planned Parenthood admits it's real, and that Margaret Sanger wasn't a racist. I mean, that's like saying Adolf Hitler wasn't a racist. I mean, it's just, there seems to be an insanity, because I'm not left or right, I'm just a libertarian like you. There seems to be a mental illness insanity by the so-called left today where they are lying and telling whoppers bigger than Al Gore, saying he invented the internet. What do you make of this, Dr. Grupp?
Well, it's just a sick process that's going on. I mean, you mentioned mental illness, and that, to me, is another weapon that the governments are going to use for gun control. Because if you think about the push to put every single person on some form of psychiatric or psychotropic drug right now, even including pregnant women and young children as early as 3, 4, 5, the violence, the suicides, the school shootings. Look, that's an easy way to take guns away from somebody, because all they have to do is pull up your medical records and say, hey, you have a history of being on psychotropic medications. We're going to take your gun away. And now you have 8 out of 10 people being on some sort of psychotropic medication.
And it's beyond that. They're now saying in the FBI memo, if you take automatic transfer of your Social Security, that you're inept.
Right. If you leave a psychiatrist's office without a medication, they actually have a code in the DSM saying you're crazy for leaving the office without accepting a prescription. So, I mean, I think the Planned Parenthood, that goes back to Bill Gates' organization.
We're going to skip this break.
That goes back to eugenics. That goes back to the control of the population. It all goes back to the multitude of things that they're bombarding us with, including all the environmental toxins, the endocrine-disrupting chemicals.
No wonder there's so many mental problems.
Well, exactly.
I mean, honeybees are acting insane. Other mammals are. Fish. And shrimp are committing suicide. CNN, they swim up to the birds to be eaten because of the Prozac runoff.
Right. I mean, we have so many chemicals in the water supply, the air. I mean, that's pretty much what we've linked to every single type of disease. We've been getting calls. I didn't even realize how many calls we had till the other day. I was talking to some of the guys in the customer service department, and they said that the hairs, women are calling in saying their hair is falling out.
Oh, yeah, it's everywhere. That's all over the women's sites. Their thyroids are swelling up. They're spraying aluminum on us. What's going to happen when half of us have cancer?
The radiation from Fukushima, cancer. This is a report.
How are they going to cover this up? How are they going to get away with it?
They're not. I mean, people are going to have to wake up and figure out that there's the solutions to it. I mean, it's in broad daylight. They're out there saying everything. The government is reporting on increased cancer. They're linking it to chemicals. There's environmental chemists right now coming out and doing studies on all types of different types of cosmetic products.
The FDA and EPA have said take all the fluoride out, and the globalists say no.
There's 8 billion pounds right now of BPA alone being produced every single year. There's fire retardants being produced.
Say that again.
8 billion pounds. 8 billion of BPA being
produced. And so much of that runs off in the rivers and the ocean that now upwards of half of the fish are basically have both sexual organs.
There's 2.8.
But see, we're being homophobic. It's good that they've changed.
The whole world is changing, and the problem is it's not only affecting us as the humans, it's affecting the pets, it's affecting all of the animals on the planet, it's affecting the fish, the herbs, the trees.
Is this like an Oblivion plot line that aliens are doing this or something? I say that more and more because it's so diabolical. And then we get the documents, they're doing it on purpose. Who are these people?
I don't know, but I mean, my main focus is on the solutions, just like you, telling people what they can do. I mean, there's a lot of different things out there that we could talk about, the negative of everything. But really, what people want to hear is they want to hear, okay, what are some of the solutions we can do? I just found out that fragrances, I mean, I've known about the toxic effects of fragrances. And fragrances, for anybody who doesn't know, your dryer sheets, anything that smells nice, anything you buy in the grocery store, even foods that are sitting next to fragrances now are being contaminated with chemicals.
Oh, I get sick when I walk through the grocery store. When I was a kid, my eyes would burn. I'd get a headache walking through the Tom Thumb grocery store through the chemical aisle. Or when I would be at the hardware store, walking by the pesticide aisle, my eyes would burn. I'd get a headache.
So fragrance, if it says natural fragrance or anything on a label, that fragrance can contain anywhere from 12, usually 12 is the minimum, to over 200 toxic chemicals in that fragrance alone. And doing more research into this, I found that fragrances aren't even required to put on the labels. Natural flavors.
Because it's grandfathered and proprietary.
Exactly. And fragrances are not, they don't need to be listed on the MSDS sheets, the material safety data sheets that are required by the government for any type of supplement or any type of chemical. Fragrances are not allowed.
And let me give them a big conspiracy. Just like cigarette companies spent tens of billions with up to 300 chemicals per cigarette brand to make it more addictive, where the chemicals are what you were addicted to, not even the nicotine. And that's what caused so much of the cancer. Not that tobacco's good either. But just like foods and designer food additives, as you know, your dad was a top chemist, was also to make food addictive. And so you want to keep eating it. The Doritos, the McDonald's. Well, it's the same thing with fragrances. They want to make their brand of poisonous dishwashing fluid, clothes washing fluid, air freshener, addictive. A lot of poisons are addictive, as folks know, so that you get addicted to their brand and they compete for more aggressive neurotoxins.
Right. They actually did a study where they tested people were getting sick next that lived next door to where the dryer vents came out outside into the outside air. So they did a study and they took samples of the dryer air coming out. And they found, I think, 46 different VOCs, volatile organic compounds and toxic chemicals.
It's a conspiracy.
That were restricted by the EPA and listed as toxic air contaminants coming out everywhere into the air from everybody using dryer sheets and toxic laundry detergent.
They got us. Listen, Hitler just got shut down because they were in competition. It'd be like one Don in an Italian mob taking out another Don, not because they're against the mafia, but they're just taking over. And Hitler, again, had the plan to put all these poisons in food and water so the populations they were dominating didn't know they were being dumbed down. And they've done it to us. They really did it, Dr. Group. Soft kill.
It's a soft kill because every person has a different reaction to different chemicals. Like, let's say someone can die from eating a peanut, right? If they're allergic to peanuts. And everybody has different reactions to different chemicals. So that's why they use a combination of chemicals, environmental pollutants, chemicals in the food, the water, the phthalates, the endocrine disrupting chemicals.
They're mad scientists.
I mean, sunscreen.
Why do you think in the 50s in comic books, the Joker was always putting poison in cosmetics and other products so he couldn't get caught poisoning people? They were telling us what they were doing then. That's what the Joker does. I'm so sick of these people, man. Ugh, I hate them.
Yeah, I'm telling you. The good news is there's a solution. I tell you what, I'm constantly looking into cleansing and detoxification. We're going to be talking about a new product here pretty soon. But we looked at And actually, there was a study done. There was a guy that wrote a book called Talks In, Talks Out. And he actually looked at what type of chemicals were secreted in your sweat. Because the body has, women have five ways to eliminate chemicals and toxins. And these can be any type of chemical. You're going to breathe them out with heavy respiration, with exercise. You're going to sweat them out. You're going to defecate them out. You're going to urinate them out. And women have menses for their menstrual cycle to get rid of toxins.
Is that why they're estimated they live about 6 years longer?
Yes, but I mean, right now, all the menstrual cycles in practically every woman is messed up and not regular.
Oh, yeah.
And everybody's not having two bowel movements a day. Nobody's urinating enough because they're not drinking enough water. And, you know, nobody's sweating and breathing enough because they're not exercising. So basically, we have an accumulation of chemicals, soup of chemicals and toxins coming in, and nobody's letting them out.
Well, everybody I know is freaking out. I mean, everyone I know knows a young person dying of cancer. It's scary.
It is.
I mean, it is scary. I'm going to get really serious about detoxifying even more and only eating organic and moving out to the country. And I've already had a place in the country, but it's just not right. I got to get something where I can really get organic.
Well, this guy went into a sauna and started measuring people, taking sweat samples, and he found out that our body is so effective at detoxification, I mean, especially when you have a clean liver and clean intestines, that he could actually measure a lot of the phthalates, BPAs, chemicals, and toxins coming out through the sweat. So it's just a good free tip for people out there. If you really want to detoxify, not only is it good to take all these additional supplements that we have developed for InfoWars Life, but also
sure.
Sweat. I mean, it's free. Go just sweat. Sweat the
get in the steam room. Go for a hike. Let me ask you this question. Almost everyone I know dying of cancer or has died is either a child or a woman. And I've seen the numbers that, like, lung cancer, ABC News reported a few years ago, is up sevenfold in women. From your research, what's happening to women? I read they're three times more likely now with thyroid. It seems like they're being targeted.
I think there's a lot of different factors. Number one, their endocrine system is different than the male. Their thyroid is four times larger. They're a little more sensitive because of their cycle and their...
But they're historically tougher.
They usually live longer than men. I mean, historically, women live...
But like gunshot wounds, anything, women, doctors will tell you, are more resilient unless it's just an upfront brutal attack.
Right. My mom actually was shot six times point blank range in the head with a .22 rifle, and she survived.
Good Lord, I didn't know that story.
Well, you were talking about resiliency. So
wow.
She survived that. But I think that when you take a reproductive system of a woman and then you alter it so much, because men are usually higher in testosterone. Women are higher in estrogen. What's happening is women are spiking so high in estrogen, and estrogen is a cancer-causing substance. They're spiking so high in estrogen that their progesterone levels and testosterone levels are falling so low. So you're getting these more cancer-causing molecules besides the fact that they're deficient in also...
So how do women naturally...
In iodine, but also sure. Women use... 10
more
times the amount of perfume
products.
And fragrances and cosmetics that they rub on their skin than men do. And that is a huge problem that we're dealing with right now.
When we come back or start telling me, how does a woman block the overproduction of estrogens or artificial estrogens, and how do men do it? Because I went and had my blood tested by a medical doctor about a year ago, and they said, no, you've got high testosterone. Most men, it's really low nowadays. Yours is actually pretty good. The problem is it's converting to estrogen, and you've got estrogen mimickers in you. So what do you do naturally to block that?
What you do, the first thing I always do is have them do a liver cleanse or maybe a couple liver cleanses, because that's really when your liver becomes congested. There's two organs the medical profession never wants you to learn about. One is the intestines, and the second one is the liver. The liver is the only organ in the body that regenerates completely or regrows itself within 90 days.
That's right.
So that's why it's there. The liver performs over 500 different functions. It's so important to make sure that you have a clean and functioning liver and a healthy gut. Everything starts from there. And if that's messed up, then your estrogen's not going to be produced.
You know what? I feel everything a little bit intellectually like threatened by you. I'm just going to call you a racist. Now I'm better than you. Oh.
Well, then you might need to be on some mental medication.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
We're better detox.
We'll be back. We're going to go over these other articles. We've got Dr. Group here with us in studio. And he wants to take some phone calls, questions or comments about toxins, about what's in the household, about ways to detox. So the toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. And I think we need to fire up my call board in here. I guess that turned off or something. But 800-259-9231, and we'll take some of your phone calls. Dr. Group, again, is my guest in studio. The reason I like to have him in sometimes, he's a good friend of mine, really smart, knows his stuff, and he's all about solutions. 168 chemicals you unknowingly smear on your face this morning. And remember, a lot of drugs you put on your skin to be absorbed. The skin is the biggest organ. This is crazy. Feminine care products increases women's exposure to harmful chemicals. We'll go into that breakdown. This futuristic bracelet tells you how toxic your environment is. Is your child's coloring with asbestos? That's another article Group wants to get into, because this is crazy. And it's not just that they're getting rid of byproducts of the petrochemical industry and then just putting it in things so we pay for it. That's part of it. But even when they have ways to put out safer products, they don't do it, even though that's a whole other market for them. And then you learn this is by design. But regardless, they're not doing anything about it. Dr. Group, please continue.
Well, this is one of the most shocking things, is that they just found out that cancer-causing asbestos fibers were found in several children's crayon brands. And,
why are you hating on asbestos?
Because I'm trying to protect the children. I mean,
are you an asbestos phobe?
There. I am an asbestos phobe. I'm a chemical and toxic everything phobe. I mean, one of the reasons that I really wanted to come on today was to let people know that they are exposed to so many different chemicals in their home every single day, from fragrances to environmental pollutants to VOCs in the air, to BPA, to phthalates, to glyphosate, the artificial colors, the artificial sweeteners, you know, asbestos. And who would have thought? They buy their kids crayons and they're breathing toxic compounds. But another reason why is to announce that we spent over a year trying to put together something for somebody, for everybody, especially working with Alex and the team over here at InfoWars Life, to create a product that would focus on helping people clean environmental chemicals and toxins from their body and how to detox those from the system. We have a lot of good products over here, from the X2 for the, you know, all of the liver cleanse products, the Oxy powder, the Winter Sun. I mean, you name it, down the line, everything is great. Today, though, I'm really excited because this is something that you guys have the exclusive for, which is a product called Deep Cleanse that we have that is going to be launched today. And why I'm so excited about it is it's a unique formula, almost like the iodine crystals. We have two unique products that nobody in the world has.
And we knew this was going to be big, so I did this time order a ton of it. So we do have it stockpiled. We did get a ton of it in, freshly made. And it's got the best, which one of our graphics people designed this? The label is beautiful, but what's really important is what's in it. And explain the manufacturing process. You cold press and concentrate this. That's why the super male, the super female, all this stuff blows people's socks off. And we wanted to come out with the ultimate deep cleanse for the whole body. Tell people what's in it, Dr. Group.
One of the most amazing ingredients in the world, and it's called Shilajit, and it's actually known as blood of the mountain or rock sweat, because thousands of years ago, as a matter of fact, this ingredient was only given to the elite of the elite. Thousands of years ago, up in the Himalayan mountains and in Tibet.
And we wanted to put this in stuff for a couple of years, but we couldn't get an organic form.
Right. I mean,
so let's explain. I mean, this stuff's so good, we couldn't put it out for years.
Right. So I had to actually, it's kind of like the iodine crystals, finding a source deep in the earth that we could get the cleanest source available. But in Tibet and in Nepal and in the Himalayan mountains, thousands of years ago, they watched these monkeys, and during the summer months, the monkeys would go up into the mountains.
Now you're being racist against monkeys.
And they would pick this black substance from the mountains. And so in Russia, they actually, it grows in Russia in the mountains and in the Himalayas, and only in the summer. And Shilajit is actually the decomposition of up to 7,000 different medicinal herbs. So it decomposes, all these different herbs decompose in the Himalayan mountains and the volcanic soil up there. And what happens in the summertime...
So it's almost like an oil from...
Yes, it's high in fulvic acid, it's high in humic acid.
Because they're always claiming oil is really from decomposed animals and plants. There is some oil that is based from fossils, but most of it's really abiotic. But so this is a true fossil source? I mean, explain it to me.
It is. It's really the decomposition, like I said, of over 7,000 different medicinal herbs and plants. And with the rocks and the pressure deep in the mountains, it freezes. And during the summertime and the pressures build it up.
It oozes out.
It oozes out. So it literally oozes out of the mountain.
It's like rock sap.
It's like rock sap. It's black and it's highly nutritious. Even in the 1980s, when the Olympic athletes in Russia were accused of being on steroids, they found out that they were actually been given Shilajit because it works as an anabolic as well. And it builds muscle. And as well, it increases.
So this is going to supercharge me even more. I haven't taken it yet.
This is amazing because what it's designed to do, it's actually the king of Ayurvedic herbs. Like I said, it was only given to the elite. And we have the exclusive area in the mountains that we've worked for over a year and a half to develop and get. So we get the production. It's hand harvested from the mountains. And that's the main ingredient.
And you tell me it's a big dose of it.
It's a big dose in there. The second big main ingredient in there is a volcanic zeolite concentrate. And what this formula is designed to do.
Now you're being racist against volcanoes.
Is to grab and detoxify and help cleanse your body of all these environmental chemicals and toxins because the Shilajit and the zeolites have a real strong negative charge. All the metals and chemicals and PCBs and VOCs have positive charges. So these go in, they grab it, and then they safely eliminate it through the body so you can become healthy. I mean, this is an amazing formula. I wish I actually had it, but because this was an exclusive InfoWars Life product, you're the only one in the world that has this formula now. And, you know, there is going to be a limited supply available when you sell out because you can only harvest this once a year.
Well, that's why we went ahead and doubled down and have gotten one of the biggest orders ever is because I'm sick of, well, I mean, you said they are now for industrial purposes buying up the deep earth crystals because it's used for so much drug manufacturing, not illegal drug manufacturing. Shifting gears for a moment into the iodine, why is iodine used in so much manufacturing of drugs and chemicals and everything?
Well, really, I think they're starting to see more and more radiation damage all over the world, and that's the number one use for iodine. They can soak different things in iodine solutions. They see that it works for, there's just as many pets now coming out with thyroid dysfunction, and so veterinary use for iodine. There's a lot of chemical use for iodine. They can clean chemical substances with it before they, so it's not toxic or it's not irradiated.
The point is it really is getting hard to get.
People are starting to jump on the bandwagon with iodine, and they're starting to see the demand for it. They're starting to see how effective it is, and they're starting to buy it up. And by the way, since we're talking about pets,
yeah, let's go back to the new Deep Cleanse, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com, and you help fund the savage operation and the promotion of liberty.
Pets are just as susceptible to disease as we are, and people all over the world love their pets, and they're spending a massive amount of money on their pets. And pets are exposed to massive amounts of environmental chemicals because they're close to the carpet. They're breathing in VOCs. All the pet food out there is highly contaminated. So this is also a great, and so is the X2, great to use for your pets to keep your pets healthy. To keep,
what do you do? Put it on their wet food or put it in the water? Or?
I personally just stick it right in there. I just have a dog and I just put it right in her.
That's what I do with
she loves
old dogs I've had. When I give them like Advil, I just grab their mouth and throw it in there.
I just do it for the X2 and I do it for, well, I'm going to get some deep cleansing. I'm going to be detoxing my dog from that. But my dog eats organic food anyway. So we are, all, I mean, it's proven.
You got to be a white savior to your dog?
I'm going to be a white savior to the dog. Yeah, I have a hybrid dog. It's actually called a golden doodle. It's like a, it stays a
golden. See, it's golden. racist,
puppy,
you know.
Whatever.
And again, the reason I'm being sarcastic, you have a new MTV show out where they call it microaggression, where like a brown bag is racist, or like if I have my elbows on a black table, it means it's actually I want to dominate black people. And just everything's racist. So we have to now realize that that's what this is all about.
Well, if solutions are racist, then I guess I'm racist, because the whole purpose is to provide people with solutions.
Where do you think this craziness is going, though?
I think that there's a lot of good that's happening. You know, obviously people are standing up. They're fighting more against genetically modified organisms, except now they're trying to come.
So they want to just distract us off because they know there's an awakening and we're coming together.
Right. The solution that I see, and I still have that feeling that something's going to be happening around starting around September 20th. That's kind of what I've been feeling personally. And I know you've been having those feelings too. And some nights are fine with me. And then some nights I wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
And you say you've never been like that. Me neither.
I've never been like that. I've never felt this strong about something. I mean, actually,
even on secret operations in the military, by North Korea, you never felt like that.
No, because this affects me and my family and like something big that's happening with the world. I mean, I was just back there talking to Anthony about,
you can really feel it.
You know, what to do, you know, should we take our, you know, take, I've already converted a lot of money into silver.
You've already moved out to a ranch.
And I try to tell people, make sure that you have a stock of all the things that you're going to need, because the attack, it could come through the air. It could come through the water. I mean, I was on my way up here in Bastrop and saw a sign at the Buc-ee's right there.
You sent me a photo.
FEMA. Just, you know, FEMA camp or something.
In fact, let me pull it up. Keep going. I'm going to pull it up.
So what I'm saying is right now, it seems like there's a lot of, especially with Jade Helm and everything that's happening. That's why I want to just give people answers. That's why I want to help, because I've done all the research. I've studied all these chemicals, and it's easy for me to say, look, all these high rates in cancer, all the problems that you're having with your child, all of the so-called mental illness that's out there that they're saying is caused by some dumb chemical reaction in your brain. It's not a chemical reaction in your brain. It's because your liver's toxic, your liver's congested, and you have too many chemicals coming into your body. So it's all about, that's why everything that we develop, everything I develop for InfoWars or for Global Healing Center, it doesn't matter, is all geared to help you change your environment and reduce the amount of chemicals and toxins that are
coming. And it's a win-win. You're really into reap what you sow, karma, whatever. We neurotically, it's why I went with you. It took me years to research this. Most big manufacturers, we go to them, and they're like, oh, you want to put out something quality? Wow, no one wants to do that. They just make it all about the marketing. And we're like, no, we really want to do as we would do unto others as we want to be done to us. Plus, when we end up having the best products, we'll end up dominating the market, funding our operation, and crushing the globalist. It's old-fashioned Americana. I mean, I want to have the best products.
That's why everybody else out there focuses on the symptoms. And we don't focus on the symptoms. We focus on the root cause. I mean, that's the way it should be. Everybody has a self-healing mechanism inside their own body. And it took me years to figure that out because no one ever taught me that.
Sure.
All we're doing is the best and easiest and fastest way to reactivate your body's self-healing mechanism.
Is to cleanse.
Immune system is to clean your body
out.
And
we're sold out of the liver cleanse. That's going to be back in soon. We misestimated how many people would want it. We have a lot of the deep cleanse. And quite frankly, you're even more excited about this than the liver cleanse, because go over the other things that are in it.
Well, the other thing in it is a specifically designed zeolite concentrate. Now, all the products and ingredients that were chosen for Deep Cleanse were handpicked by me, and there's many different forms of Shilajit out there, actually, too. We had to find the one that was grown in the best organic or produced in the best organic mountains. The zeolites, we actually spent years trying to concentrate those into a solution.
And what are zeolites, folks that don't know?
Zeolites are actually a combination, or they're formed hundreds of thousands of years ago, millions of years ago, when volcanic lava met seawater, okay? So when the lava from volcanoes touched the seawater, it formed a special type of compound, and that's called a zeolite.
A matrix.
And so These little tiny zeolites, which go through your body, are actually like almost structured forms that are highly charged, have a high negative charge on them, that have an affinity for any type of chemicals and toxins that
are. So it's like a super antioxidant.
It's like a super antioxidant that grabs, that goes through the blood, goes through everything, and grabs and bonds. It's like a magnet, really. It bonds to all these chemicals.
It's a hardcore formula. Your purchase supports the broadcast.
I'm going to be taking it every single day, so I'm actually going to be buying it from you guys.
And by the way, I'll tell you something that's the biggest sleeper product. We didn't even promote it. It's Secret 12, the methylcobalamin and vitamin B12. People are that order it just keep reordering it. That's one of our best sellers now with no promotion because it just works so good.
Everybody needs B12. Everybody needs vitamin D. Everybody needs vitamin. We have receptor cells, and it's the only B12 that has the adenosyl cobalt.
It's amazing. You know, I have a really amazing author scheduled to come on for just 30 minutes. I'm going to reschedule him the next week for a full hour. Anthony Esselin, who wrote Life Under Compulsion, 10 Ways to Destroy the Humanity of Your Child, because it's such an important topic. But I want to be able to take phone calls from Kathy, Bill, Robert, Spencer, Patrick, and many others that are patiently holding. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. So Dr. Grip will be with us 30 minutes in the next hour. I will, though, some of that time, get into breaking news and info and get your take on that as well. Then we're going to have Joe Biggs and Josh Owens, who were just at the border. Donald Trump said he was going down to Laredo. Then he wasn't. Now he's going back this weekend. I mean, whatever. But we caught drug smuggling going on video. Pretty powerful footage and just illustrates exactly what we're all talking about. And so they're going to be joining us the last 30 minutes. Just briefly on the deep cleanse, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Just 30 seconds on this. Then I want to go to calls, questions, and comments, Dr. Grib. How do people take it? How is it recommended that this be done? Just a daily dose?
Yeah, daily dose. The instructions are on the label. You know, of course, I kind of modify it for each individual. It depends on what your lifestyle is. I mean, honestly, the best thing to do is for you to avoid all these chemicals and toxins in your environment and try to identify them and start slowly reducing them. But personally, I'm going to probably take it every day, every other day, and I'll probably go with about a dropper full to maybe two dropper fulls. I don't expose myself to any chemicals, but...
But it's out there in the air. It's in everything. Well, I mean, I'll tell you what I do.
The air,
I've never been a supplement person. I keep it now on the kitchen table with a Lazy Susan. And when I just make myself take it all every day, I feel so much better. My problem is getting in the habit, and I still haven't done it completely.
I had a lady come into my office, actually, and her sister is an avid InfoWars fan. And she told me that her sister was sent home to die and had 2 months to live because she had a lung disease. She didn't specify what it was, if it was lung cancer or whatever. And she told me she heard us talking about the lung cleanse from InfoWars, and she purchased like 7 or 8 bottles. And she started spraying it and using the instructions like 10 times a day. And she went back to her doctor's office a month later. And her doctor said, "What in the world are you doing? Your lung condition is halfway cleared up." And she said she didn't want to tell because she watched us talking about it and she didn't want to tell her doctor what she was doing. And then the next month she went back in and her lung condition was completely gone in 2 months.
Well, a lot of the lung stuff you buy even in health food stores, you just spray it and it's only got 2 or 3 ingredients. It's real watery. This is so good, you've got to unstop the sprayer a lot because it's like thick essential oil. Explain the difference.
Well, because of all the research that I did on air pollutants, and I mean, I drove up from Houston today, and just getting here, I could tell that there was something in the air, and there's no way to avoid air. And indoor air is more toxic than outdoor air. So the reason why we did lung cleanse was to help support the natural detoxification of your lungs. I just chose the top best ingredients, therapeutic levels. We concentrate them in the formula. And now, since it's been out for a long time, I mean, you can look at the reviews and we have people that are using it for all different types of conditions. See, chemicals and toxins, they go straight into your bloodstream when you breathe them in. Whereas if they come in through the intestines, they have to go through your liver for processing. That's why the livers are so congested on everybody. But this is directly into the bloodstream through the lungs. And so when you're breathing all those chemicals in, I wanted to be able to produce something for everybody out there that they could keep their lungs clean.
And it's got a whole bunch of ingredients in it.
Especially since chemtrails are bombarding the whole world right now. So what it does is it stimulates the mucus production in your lungs, and usually you'll cough up a lot of that stuff and just spit it out. But it also helps neutralize any of the chemicals or toxins.
All right.
Coming in.
InfoWarsLife.com. Please also support our local AM and FM affiliates. Support their local sponsors or become a sponsor and spread the word. Because these aren't just great products. This is how we fund this independent operation. We're not taxpayer funded like MSNBC or NPR. And neither is your local station. So support them, folks. This is a war. Your calls in 70. Article just went live on InfoWars.com. We're going to cover it after calls. CDC tells mothers delay breastfeeding to enhance vaccine. I mean, your baby will lose weight, get brain damage if you don't get them food right away. But see, they know, and they don't want that mother shielding milk to give it sustenance so the brain damaging can't happen as bad. So the brain that's already starved for sugar just goes into total collapse. I mean, the savage evil.
The colostrum in the milk is the natural vaccine. They're trying to prevent the baby from getting the natural colostrum in the breast milk. That is sick.
Until 5 years ago, as you know, they said never give a pregnant woman a vaccine because they know it could cause a miscarriage or different disorders. Now they say give them extra. It's all about doubling down. Like, there's no Planned Parenthood. Alex made it up. They're not selling babies. Margaret Sanger wasn't racist. That's today. Double the shots. Double them. And then your kid dies, and it's fun. They're like, loving. They're like demon clowns or something. Let's go to Patrick, then Kathy, then Bill, then Robert, then Spencer. Patrick in California. You're on the air with Dr. Edward Group.
Yeah, thanks for taking my call, guys. I'm a 49-year-old male. I live in Southern California. I had a backpack of a chemical, a pesticide spill on me. Lid popped open when I put the backpack on. This happened, like I said, in 2004. So I've been dealing with, like, chemical sensitivity, low
testosterone. Don't be a conspiracy theorist. The media says pesticides are not bad. They're good for you. You're not sick.
Yeah, exactly.
Why are you being racist, sir? Why are you against Obama? See, because anytime you bring up something real, I just change the subject. That's the tactic. I'm just teaching folks how they work. I'm sorry. No, obviously, pesticides, they think, killed my dad's dad. Cooper Tox, it was basically cyanide, gave him lung cancer. But I apologize for interrupting you. Go ahead. Tell us what you're going through.
Yeah, so I'm trying to find some ways to get the stuff out of my system. I know when I exercise or do saunas, I mean, I get pretty damn sick. But I'm just trying to find some ways to get this safely out. So can you help me, doctor?
Yeah, when it starts coming out of his fat, he starts getting sick. You know, that happens as I lose weight. I'll kind of feel like crap when I go on a 10-mile hike and lose like 6 pounds. I feel great the next day. I'm kind of like, whoa, and like get some zits and feel irritable. What do you do?
Believe it or not, water is one of the best ways to detoxify. This is what
it's clear, like a white person.
Your body, is 90% water. So what I recommend is the first thing with any type of pesticide or chemical exposure like that is liver cleansing. I mean, what happens is the liver, even though the liver regenerates itself, some of those pesticides have damaged the liver cells when they went through into the blood and probably the
gut. They deserve a home.
So intestinal cleansing, gut health, as well as liver cleansing, probably like 2 or 3 liver cleanses in a row is what we've done for somebody who spilled chemicals or toxins or pesticides. But this deep cleanse is specifically designed to focus more on those environmental chemicals and pollutants. So I would highly recommend getting some.
Well, let me ask you this question.
Sweating, again.
Have you done the liver cleanse yet?
No, I haven't.
Well, let me just tell you, it's spectacular for almost everyone. I mean, we're talking on day 6, spewing green balls.
Yeah. It's one of the most effective things that I've found for detoxification.
People don't believe it. They go, I thought you were joking when you like 30, 40 green balls come out of your gallbladder and your liver. No, I mean, this really happens.
It really happens. Yes, it does. Yeah.
And then, you know, we're being racist against Martian green balls. We don't want them in our gallbladder. We're getting rid of them.
And that's why the medical science and the big pharma does not want you to learn how to repair and create a healthy gut environment and have a clean liver. Because every single person with any disease or toxicity that we've evaluated You do not get any symptoms or any disease unless your liver is functioning below 50%.
Sure, sir. And I'm sorry to be sarcastic, taking your time up. I want to hold you over and come back and get a few more minutes with you so you can finish your question. But here's the question when we come back. What type of pesticide was it that got on you? Were you working for an exterminator service or what was it?
Yeah, it was for a pest control company.
Wow, I want to hear about this when we come back. I remember, I'll tell the story when we come back. Stay with us. By the way, Dr. Group was just talking to me, joined us, and reminded me, I'll go down to the Texas coast and go deep sea fishing a couple times a year with my son and my daughters too, but they like bay fishing because it's in all the waves and they don't get seasick. And a lot of times when I go down there, they have these trucks that drive around at like midnight. And one time I was going down to the car to get something from the condo we were renting, and here comes this truck just spraying poison. And I tried to look up what they were spraying, and there was even an article about they don't have to tell because of a state contract. And we were just discussing it during the break, but the famous footage of DDT with the truck spraying the kids in the swimming pools and the kids walking behind the cars and saying, it's totally safe, just like Roundup. Well, the truth is the UN got it banned. And it probably did end up killing more people because of malaria. But still, it has side effects, let's be honest. But the new stuff, one night I was on Coast to Coast AM till 4 in the morning. And that was back when I was stupid enough to still occasionally smoke cigarettes. I smoked like a half pack a week probably. In college, maybe a pack a day. But I smoked about a half pack a week. I smoked a couple cigarettes a night. Especially when I was up late, and I was on the back porch. It was like 3 a.m. I go, I got to go to sleep. I pop a beer, 3:30, whatever. I'd gone off Coast to Coast AM, and a Cessna flies right over at like 200 feet, spraying chemicals. So I go in and I Google it. This is like 10 years ago, and it goes, sure enough, there will be moth eradication this week in Austin. But the aircraft will be flying at night, so there shouldn't be any. And I saw it, bigger than Dallas, flying, spraying stuff on me. And it's like, what are they spraying? So we were going to go back to Patrick, who worked for a pesticide company, and talk about what just one exposure of it dumping on him did. Imagine how he was breathing that every day, or the little bit that got on his skin. That, see, he got hit hard, and it made him sick, and he knew it. But soft kill is cumulative, so you were going to talk about that.
Well, I had a lady that came into my office about 2 years ago in Houston. Apparently, they changed up or strengthened the spray, the pesticide spray, because the same thing. In the summertime, for about 3 months, about midnight to 1 o'clock in the morning, you'll hear the truck coming through your neighborhood spraying. And I've been trying to get them to stop. Of course, you know, there's nothing you can do about it because it's so secretive. But she, about 2 years ago, someone who mixed it or whatever, they sprayed at night and everybody woke up in the morning that had plastic mailboxes in Houston and the mailboxes were literally melted. So, and it was a big deal and a bunch of people were sick and they went to the city and they said, we want you to replace our mailboxes. What in the world were you spraying that melted our mailboxes? And they denied it, and they tried to get the list of ingredients, and it was just a bunch of red tape. And to this day, we still haven't found out what they ended up spraying that night. So we know that there's some massive, hardcore chemicals being sprayed at night. What can you do about that?
But then we've got Patrick. Patrick, for folks that just joined us without me interrupting with sick jokes, and I apologize, that's how I cope, though, because this gets me really upset. I either blow up or I make jokes, and I apologize for that, but... talk about what happened to you specifically. Go ahead.
Yeah, Alex, I was a pest control applicator. I was working for a company, and basically I put the backpack of the chemical up onto the, you know, you have the sprayer and you put on the lip of the truck. And then when I was, you know, popping it on my back, you know, the liquid popped open the lid and basically soaked into my back of my shirt. I mean, it really doused me. And immediately I developed chemical sensitivity. I didn't know it at the time, but I felt like I was in like a fog, you know. And, you know, the following day I came back out to spray and I'm like, man, why do I feel like I have the flu every time I'm breathing this in? I went to the coworkers and I was like, do you guys feel sick when you spray this? And they go, oh, no. So I didn't realize I was already injured.
That's the thing. You're a conspiracy theorist when you get sick from it.
Yeah, exactly.
Did they ever tell you, did you ever know exactly what chemicals that you were spraying?
Yeah, I do. It was a chemical called fipronil, They used a lot in the dog collars, I found out. And when I looked up the MSDS, it showed that it does cause drastic alterations in testosterone and also thyroid tumors. And I'm dealing with some nodules in my thyroid right now.
Oh, yeah. My goodness.
Well, that's another good reason to be on the X2. You know, any type of thyroid conditions, whether it's Hashimoto's, hypothyroidism, hyperthyroidism, usually is linked to an iodine deficiency. Although we do highly recommend you check with your qualified healthcare practitioner to get an evaluation done. So, Patrick, thanks for the call. You want to move on to...
Absolutely. That was a really informative caller. But notice he got a big dose, so it hit him. He knew it did it. But the little dose, you just slowly ease into the fog. And that was a story I was going to tell. I didn't know he's about to do that. One time, because I have a cousin who was... He finally got out of the Army after 35 years. He's an older cousin. And there were a few times where, well, I was working with him, but also his brother, my other cousin, and they would just go out for extra money and do termite stuff. And so my grandma would just say, when I was down there for a few weeks during the summer, I was like 10 when this happened, hey, go work with them, you know, because they'd send me to all different types of jobs just to get experience. And I remember going under houses with them, spraying, doing three or four houses, going and getting lunch, and just being high, even though I was wearing a mask, high at the Dairy Queen eating a hamburger after I'd gone and just done a few houses. And it was just so clear that I was high off the poison. And that's just what he was just saying. He spilt it on himself and then was just in a daze. And that's what the general public's like. We're stunned in a daze, Dr. Group.
Yes, that's exactly what's happening, and that's why we're here giving out solutions.
Let's talk to Kathy in Michigan. You're on the air.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead, Kathy.
Yes, hi, doctor. I noticed it's been a couple weeks, mostly on my husband's side, on our sheets. It's been staining with like a bluish gray color, and it's like from the upper torso and the lower torso. And I just changed the sheets a little while ago, and I noticed my second sheets are ruined. And
so you're saying blue is coming out of your husband?
Yes, it's like a bluish gray color on his side of the sheets. And I noticed his white T-shirts have been missing. I noticed that yesterday. And he's been wearing these beige T-shirts to bed. And even I see a little bit coming underneath his armpit of the color. And I just wonder...
Dr. Grip, do you have any idea what that could be?
Well, it could be a multitude of things. I don't know if he's changed and he's using a new type. If he's using a body lotion, for example, that can mix with different chemicals in sweat and cause different colors. If he's doing a different type of deodorant. I mean, the first thing I would look at is he putting anything on his skin that's reacting with his sweat that's maybe changing colors?
Or maybe it's a new detergent that's reacting with his skin?
A new detergent. I would look at the environmental factors and then see what's changed around that time before. If you weren't noticing that before and you're noticing it now, there's something that he's doing or that he's exposing himself to that needs to be looked at, because I'm glad you're noticing that. A lot of people don't pay attention to
that. Well, if you asked him, you say he's wearing a beige shirt now. Was he trying to cover this up?
But I tell you, I'm going to ask him today. And also, he works with a lot of chemicals at GM, and he does a lot of Roundup around our property in the country. And also, he uses what was called Iron Out. And I said, get this out of the house. I can't stand that smell. They take the stains out of our sinks and our bathtubs. And he don't even put a mask on when he does that.
Well, I notice a lot of chemical people are actually like, they don't know they're like huffers, but they are, and they're all into more chemicals, and they pour them everywhere, and they mess with them, and they're basically bombed out of their brains.
Yeah, I would highly suggest that you pull up some information. You can type any glyphosate or any of that in InfoWars search bar and pull up a lot of information.
Credit. Yeah, their PR guy kept saying, I'll drink it. So they go, drink it. And he goes, no way.
Right.
You think I'm crazy?
I mean, the thing is, especially with glyphosate, it's parts per billion that can affect you and work as an endocrine disrupting chemical. It's not like you need to drink.
And if you want to grow giant tumors, knock yourself out. Well, God bless you, man. Appreciate your call. Bill and
definitely
Michigan.
Have them detoxify.
Absolutely. But if you've had a lot of pesticide exposure, it might not feel too good, right?
No, you might go through some sort of reaction. As a matter of fact, I mean, when you start pulling all these things out of your system, you might feel worse for the first 2, 3, 4 days before your body starts.
Well, you said 2 to 3 weeks for the iodine. But you're saying this may be the first.
Iodine, you're talking about pulling deep bromines and chlorines.
So this is 3-4 days, though.
That, it just depends on how many chemicals and toxins everybody has. The thing is, you can't predict. Sure. Everybody's different.
Sure. Bill in Michigan, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi, guys. Hey, God bless you both. I want to start with you, Alex. So far, my gut tells me you're a good guy, not a bad guy like some people push on YouTube. Sorry for my voice. I went to the Deftones concert last night. Now, I pray my gut is correct because I've gone all in with InfoWars. I'm committed to it.
Well, thank you, brother.
Planet. I buy everything.
Well, we couldn't do it without you. It's hard to fund this operation. That's why every few weeks we, you know, kind of fund things here. Absolutely, sir. I mean, I'm all in. Don't just believe me. Trust but verify. The world government's unfolding in front of everybody. I mean, the Pope just called for world government.
Checking it all out, and so I got to trust my gut on this one. Also, Alex, my license plate says Info War.
Well, God bless you, brother. Thank you.
Okay, so Dr. Group, I'm a 53-year-old white male, fruitarian, with no gallbladder, and my drink mix that I take every day is it fills up a quart jar. It's got orange juice, 8 drops of X. Two straws of Secret 12, 2 straws of D3, a scoop of One World Way, about half an ounce of hydrosol silver. Am I messing myself up with this thing?
Well, first of all, it's very rare to hear from a fruitarian, so congratulations on that. No, you're not. I mean, even fruitarian.
I mean, should you take silver every day?
You can if you want. It's definitely not going to harm you. I mean,
I just take it when everybody's got really bad bacterial infections around me.
Well, the thing is, we're exposed to different types of microorganisms every single day, and that's why, you know, I guess we'll talk about now. We're going to be launching a product here, another exclusive product on InfoWars 2 that is going to be addressing the parasites and the harmful organisms in the body, which is probably going to be, you know, then we'll have the full spectrum of everything everybody needs. But yes, we're exposed. Doesn't matter if you're, you know, drinking, juicing, a raw vegan, we're exposed to these things every single day. So usually I like to try to give the body a chance, the self-healing mechanism, to try to work on its own. So I'll try to take things one day and then give the body a day rest and then take things the other day. So you can kind of balance out your schedule.
Yeah, I mean, don't you gauge for yourself what feels better?
Ultimately, yes. I mean, ultimately, we are our own physician, our own doctor. It's just that we're never trained. I mean, really, what should happen in every single school when children start going to school is there should be classes on teaching the children how to be their own physician and how to reactivate their body.
What makes sense to me is they ought to learn how to wash dishes, do laundry, be polite. Basic stuff, how to grow food, and then reading, writing, arithmetic, and just how to be good humans. Instead, they just teach them how to be a bunch of ninnying, screwed up people fighting with each other in peer pressure.
Whiners and complainers is what is really what we have today, is just a bunch of whining and complaining, toxic, sick children that are living on high fructose corn syrup and artificial colors and artificial sweet.
Sure. God bless you, Bill. I appreciate your support. I want to say something to Bill. I don't respond to the internet detractors that make up everything under the sun here about us, you know, that we work for the Vatican, but we expose what the Vatican's doing, or we work for Israel just because we don't want to blow Israel up, or this is how people make themselves feel big, is looking at us that have built something unique with your help to try to fight the globalists. We're having some success. We try to support other activists and other people to fight the New World Order. We're all in this together. And so when people are attacking us, ask yourself this. Are they giving any solutions? Are they spending 95% of their time fighting the New World Order, warning people about dangers of vaccines, GMO, trying to get fluoride out, trying to stop the gun confiscation, trying to control our open borders? Or do they just spend their time all day going, this person's bad, that person's bad, this person isn't perfect? You know, I know who's bad, the globalist. I know who's taken over. I know their names. I expose them. I go up against real people. I don't sit here, and it's an admitted Cass Sunstein. It goes back to the Clintons, how they would finance groups to start infighting and then get other people on the bandwagon in a snowball effect to then repeat it to where our whole movement is a bunch of people fighting with each other. The good news is we've been transcending that as the New World Order gets out in the open. People don't want to hear that anymore. They're done. Okay? So here's the deal. Don't trust me. Trust yourself. World government's here. It's tyrannical. What are you going to do about it? I mean, we're open. I got a 20-year track record. I don't need to defend myself. I'm actually ashamed of myself, I'll be honest with you. The amount of power I have, the amount of people that listen, it's humbling to have people call in who are smart and eloquent and caring and to be counting on me. I'm sick of everybody having to count on me. And I'm not mad or complaining. It's just that I'm a responsible person that has three children and a whole operation to run. And I get mad at myself when I act like a jerk. I get mad at myself when I blow up. I get mad at myself when I get frustrated. But that's why people listen, because they know it's real. But that's what it comes down to. And I'm not mad that I get lied about and attacked by people in the so-called liberty movement. They're mentally ill losers, or they're being government financed. Okay? I got other bigger enemies coming after me I got to deal with that are life-threatening. Okay? Now, that's separately. Then you have White House-run outlets saying, I'm lying about this, I'm lying about that, I want to kill police, I'm a racist, to set me up. And you know what? I expect that. I expect to be attacked because I'm having an effect. I'm in a death battle, in an information war with the globalist. I believe what I say because it's true. And we're effective, and we're here to break people out of their trance. So I love it. Everybody attack me. Bring it on. I'm committed. That's what gives me my energy. I'm never going to stop. Understand that. You'll have to face your creator, though, on the day of judgment for what you've done, people out there that lie all day. Instead of warning innocence, instead of helping people, you spend all day up there on your high horse with how great you are. We would have already defeated the globalists if we didn't buy into all this backbiting and infighting and behavior. Dr. Group, I'm ranting. Sorry. You have anything to say on that subject?
No, not really.
Let's go to Robert. Truth. Let's go to Robert in Missouri. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Mr. Jones. How are you?
Good, brother. Thanks for holding.
Oh, no problem. I was excited to speak with you. I just love it when you turn your show into just a big infomercial when you have this hippie doctor on and you guys try to sell all your snake oil.
Exactly. Did we screen your phone call?
Yeah, but I was able to get around it.
Okay, so you just lied. Because we don't screen phone calls. We ask where you're calling from, what your name is, if you volunteer, how you're listening, or what you want to cover. It helps us. So you just had to add the added layer of BS that we don't allow people on that disagree with us.
Well, I mean, that's just
first of all, he doesn't even know, and he's calling me a snake oil. But the thing is,
let's stop right there. If you open up Time Magazine, it's full of vitamin ads, and we know ours are better. It's okay for me to self-fund. Is it more moral for NPR to get $400+ million of taxpayer money and then be funded by the Rockefeller Foundation? Or is it more moral for me to sell high-quality products that I believe in that people through free will can buy? How is it dirty in your inverted world for Planned Parenthood to sell baby organs so they can get Lamborghinis, but it's bad if I sell high-quality methylcobalamin and vitamin B12? How is that bad? Go ahead.
Well, first of all, they're not selling like aborted baby parts, like doll parts. They're selling tissue for research. So you can just stop that right there.
There you go. This is a seminar caller.
Right off the bat.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, you've blown the entire situation out of proportion and made that whole thing into something that it never was in the first place. We've already had this discussion about abortion.
Let me guess. Do you agree with the White House run salon that Margaret Sanger was not a racist?
I don't think so, sir. How could she possibly be a racist if she's in charge of a great organization like Planned Parenthood? I mean, it's better to be in charge of an organization like Planned Parenthood than one that sends Joe Biggs down south to Mexico all the time. I don't know. He must have some sort of actual fascination with, like, donkey shows or something, and I think that's why you're sending him down there. But I was also wondering if there's any sort of snake oil that you can sell me to cure my homosexuality.
Okay. Listen. If you got a serious point or you got a problem with one of the products, we didn't get $2 billion of stimulus money like NBC to give Rachel Maddow a raise. Okay. I don't get taxpayer money. I'm proud of what I do. And I'm done talking to you. We got serious questions. You got any comeback to that?
No, I mean, obviously he hasn't done his research, because if he does, he'll know that we're just involved to help people and we're teaching people how to reactivate their body's self-healing mechanism.
I mean, look, you take this iodine, it'll blow your socks off.
To causing cancer or causing disease. I mean, it's not rocket science. I mean, we're not trying to sell anybody.
Well, of course we're trying to make money. We got to fund our operation and we sell high quality products.
But we're saving
people's
lives.
Since when is that bad? I mean, it's upside down world.
Why is he even listening to the show anyway? I mean, has he tried any of the products?
Yeah, go take your vaccines, punk, okay? Go drink your fluoride. Spencer in Washington, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, thanks for taking my call, Alex, Dr. Group. That last caller was baffling. But so just a quick background. I'm a 35-year-old white male, 12-year Army veteran with a 90% disability. Last year, in February, I had a mini stroke, a transischemic attack. When I went down to the VA hospital, they did MRIs and CTs and all that kind of stuff, and they found something growing on my thyroid. And now it's been about a year-long battle trying to get seen by the VA to find out what's going on.
Oh, yeah, they're putting you on a don't treat list to kill you. I bet that makes you a little angry.
It makes me very angry. I'm a devout listener to your show, and anybody that doesn't believe in the VA don't treat list needs to pull their head out of the sand.
Todd, brother, stay there. We got Joe Biggs coming in, but I'm gonna have you for a few more minutes, a few more calls. Then we'll play a clip or something, and then get them in here. But I want to be able to finish up with Chris and Spencer and a few others. It makes me sick. They admittedly have a computer that decides not to treat them. And they can just go in and snip that cancer out or whatever it is, and they won't do it. But that's moral, though. Selling something that makes your thyroid healthy, that's immoral. All right, I got Joe Biggs and Josh Owens coming in here.
Because there is a war on for your mind.
That's right, the Alex Jones Show, there's a war on for your mind. They're going to be coming in studio. We're going to re-air that video and breakdown of the drug mules pouring in across the border. Some of the most powerful footage ever shot of this happening. And, of course, they were down there to cover Donald Trump, who was supposed to get down there yesterday and today. Now he's going down to Laredo in the South Texas border region of the Rio Grande on Saturday. And if Biggs wants to go back down, he's welcome to. I'm not going to make him work on the weekend. But he's a go-getter. He likes to work hard. So does Josh Owens. So does all of our reporters. But Biggs comes through almost all the time. He has that luck. You know, I have that, too, when I go out and do a report. Just weird stuff starts happening. And I guess God just puts us at the right place at the right time. Or it's so bad down there, it's just ubiquitous. But I want to cram in a few final calls here for Dr. Group. Since that caller was following his White House talking point that's been put out by Media Matters, Rachel Maddow, I'm told, I've seen it twice, but three times the last month, has made fun of us for super male vitality. By the way, it was selling good, but as soon as she did that, her audience isn't that big. But I guess her audience, though, that was there did go check it out. It's kind of like you attack Donald Trump, his numbers go up. We sold out real quick. So thank you, Rachel Maddow. You said it's horrible and we're bad, and it sold out. But Deep Cleanse is here, known concentrated herbs to help pull out toxins out of the body, and multi-years in the making, now available, InfoWarsLife.com. And so thank you for calling in and saying I'm a con artist and evil and bad. I'm very proud of myself. I'm very proud of the work I've done. I'm proud that our reporters continue, whether it's Jakari Jackson or Leanne McAdoo or John Bowne or just all of them, Kit Daniels, Adon Salazar, Mikhail Phelan, the list goes on and on. Just wonderful people, Paul Watson, Steve Watson. You know, we've got an incredible team here that makes national news on important issues every day now. And sometimes the top story every month or so worldwide is us. And we're affecting change, and we're proud of it, and we're proud of what we've done. And so spit on us all you want. We love it. We know we're doing the right thing. I'm sorry, Dr. Grip, I'm ranting.
No, that's okay. Let's finish up with that last caller.
Absolutely. We were talking to Spencer in Washington about thyroid issues, Army veteran. And has thyroid problems and has lumps on his thyroid, and they won't give him treatment. Spencer, please continue.
Well, so the entire thing about it is I went to the Mount Vernon Clinic in Washington, and they told me that they're not accepting new patients and that I needed to call the Veterans Choice Program, which is entirely not related to the VA at all. And I got the runaround for, it's going on a year now. So my question for Dr. Group is what homeopathic remedies can I do until I actually, if ever, get in to get looked at?
Spencer,
you worked at the VA.
I actually did my internship at the VA hospital in rheumatology, and it was horrifying what I saw.
And now it's worse.
And hey, I'm a veteran. I would never go to the VA hospital. I mean, after I almost got kicked out of the program there because I was trying to help people and I was bucking the system. I almost lost my internship. You will not get help from the VA. The VA is going to give you the runaround, and you're going to be in the system. And even if you do get to the VA, they're going to prescribe you toxic medications, which are not going to help your thyroid.
But something's changed. Now they're just turning away almost everybody and just keep saying, don't have your file, don't have your file. Biggs went in there like 15 times. It's happening to almost everybody now.
Yeah,
unless you were a little bootlicker globalist, suddenly you get all the care.
Right. It's really sad because we talk to military personnel all the time, and we try to help them as much as we can. A lot of them are dealing, they're already on medications when they come out of the military, usually antipsychotics, antidepressants, anti-anxiety, drugs for PTSD. They put them on those medications, again, what I think is to help, you know, control guns in the future, but also to be able to label them as being mentally ill. There's only one way, unfortunately, that you can help yourself, and that is to help yourself. And cleansing, you know, cleansing your liver with the Liver Shield. Iodine is highly effective at balancing out the thyroid. You know, we don't lie. I mean, people's responses and results do not lie. That's why InfoWars Life has a third-party review system. You can go read thousands of reviews. I mean, that in itself should show you that what we're doing is right and what we're doing is effective. I highly recommend that you start cleansing your body, starting with your intestines, then moving on to your liver, and then using some of the products like Deep Cleanse, the X2, and for that matter, the majority, as many InfoWars Life products as you can, because that's addressing the root cause, drinking more water.
I just had an idea. Because it's liquid and it's better. We can come out with like a multivitamin mineral syrup that's concentrated that has all the most powerful stuff if it doesn't have counter effects, and call it snake oil.
84 different.
That is awesome.
Listen, you have it. Deep Cleanse. There's 84 different minerals and vitamins and amino acids.
I should have called this snake oil. I'm proud of that name.
I'm telling you what, a lot of the snake oil actually works. What they determine as snake oil has better efficacy than any pharmaceutical. As a matter of fact, any pharmaceutical is just going to cause liver toxicity and more chemical toxicity within your body.
Well, thanks, it's Spencer. Just ridiculous. It's just Big Pharma wants to demonize anything else out there. Is there bad stuff out there? Yes. Is there great stuff out there? Yes. They just want to say, no, we're the only game in town. Well, God bless you, Spencer. Sorry to hear about that situation. But I've had dramatic effects, just more water, more exercise, everything you were talking about.
Yeah, there are cost-effective ways to get healthy, and that's increasing your exercise, increasing your sweating, drinking tons of water, and eliminating all the chemicals and toxins that you're taking in your environment.
I got to get Joe Biggs and Josh Owens in here, so I'm going to give each caller 1 minute. Chris in Mass, you're on the air. Go ahead. Thanks for holding.
What's up, guys? How are you?
Good, brother. Go ahead.
Good. So, Dr. Group, I wanted to tell you a story about 8 years ago, somehow I got contracted with Giardia, and, obviously it was a parasite, had to go through a course of antibiotics, and after I went through that, it got rid of the Giardia, but it really screwed up my stomach pretty good, and went through a whole couple of years of, getting heartburn all the time after that, and kind of figured out on my own how to treat myself as far as getting off like the products like ranitidine and all that type of stuff, and started taking enzymes and probiotics, and basically cured the gastro reflux disease on my own. But excuse me. So recently I noticed that I was getting the signs of Giardia again. So I did the research on my own and found your product Paratrex from Global Healing Center and went through a whole course of that, and it completely cured all the symptoms of what I thought was, you know, coming back again. So I just wanted to tell you, you know, thank you for coming out with that product as
you
well.
Bet. He set the private, right, he set the private label that for InfoWarsLife.com.
Right. It's in the works right now. It's going to be called Paracleanse, and we're going to do a big show about that. We haven't talked much about the attack of the microorganisms that we're facing every single day and how every single person out there has an overgrowth of microorganisms, harmful ones, fungus, bacteria, viruses,
yeast,
everything, yeast, candida, and mold, actually. So we're going to be doing a whole segment on that. We're going to be launching that Paracleanse product because every single person.
Very exciting. Thank you so much. Got to move quick. Denise in Illinois, thanks for calling. You're on the air with Dr. Group.
Yeah, hi, guys. Send me some more of that snake oil. It really works good, especially the vitamin B12.
We're not even promoting that, and it's like one of the best sellers now because word of mouth.
It's amazing. It really is. I take it practically every day.
Yeah, I've tried everything. I have multiple sclerosis. I've had it since 99, and I'm on a bunch of stuff now, hydrocodone, gabapentin at high dosages. I just want to know, what is the best thing to help control pain? I do exercise. I try to eat right, but, limited finances. I can't eat all organic.
I understand.
What would be the best product that I could take to help myself?
Well, oregano oil works extremely effective in about 80% of the people. Some say it works as strong as morphine. But as your body becomes healthy and you become cleansed with the X2, doing the liver cleansing, repairing your gut with the oxy powder, taking a good probiotic, it's amazing what happens when your body becomes clean. Then your body can take care of the pain and start healing itself. But I would also recommend, if you said you had MS, there was a doctor in Germany. His name was Hans Nieper. He wrote a book called The Curious Man, and he was probably the world's leading expert on autoimmune disease, and he has different programs, all-natural programs. So I would highly recommend taking a look into that.
Sure. God bless you, man. We got to go. We have unlimited calls coming in, but Dr. Group's got to go, and he's going to be on the nightly news tonight. We're going to get Joe Biggs and Josh Owens here in a moment. But thank you for helping us develop a proprietary product just for InfoWars Life. You're very proud of it. We're proud of it. Deep Cleanse, InfoWarsLife.com. And we're not saying any of this is a silver bullet. It's all been working great for me. You've heard the rave reviews. We're with a major third-party review site. And it's just unparalleled, unprecedented five-star reviews, thousands of them. And there's other major sites reviewing it. They're going, man, this crazy right-wing guy. I'm not even crazy right-wing, folks. But a lot of the liberals are like, these really are good supplements, you know, the supplement snobs, because you're one of the top guys out there and you don't compromise. So thank you for your help, Dr. Group.
Thank you. And I, from what I hear, the Deep Cleanse is almost sold out. So I would highly recommend everybody getting online right now.
They just told you that? Okay. Well, folks, thanks for the support. God bless you. We're going to go to this report. This is the real journalism going on. This is what Joe Biggs and Josh Owens just shot down at the border last night. In the twilight, and then they're going to be in studio with us straight ahead. Stay with us.
Joe Biggs here with InfoWars.com. Now, you might be asking yourself as to why I'm sitting in front of this random white backdrop. That's because right now Josh Owens and I are currently on the run from a cartel. Now, we got very, very golden footage, the kind of footage that most reporters would wait their entire life in hopes to get and probably would never, ever get a chance. We actually witnessed a drug smuggling operation from Mexico into the U.S. Now, this is intense. We were seen by spotters. They walked up. They got pictures of our license plate. They got pictures of me. And that's why we're doing this. This is not a joke. We had to take our license plate off our vehicle. We had to hide the vehicle. And now we are in hiding. And we're hoping we can get this footage out to you guys so you can see. Because the reason we came out here was to talk about Donald Trump, because he's coming out here to visit Laredo. And one of the things he wanted to talk about was how our borders are so wide open. Now we have proof for the American people to show you just how wide open the borders are, to show you how easy it is for a large amount of drugs to come across the Rio Grande River and into the back of a vehicle to speed away into the unknown. This is a real problem, and now we're going to take a look at that footage. As you can see, we're sitting on the side of the border right here, the Rio Grande River, I should say, in Laredo, Texas. There are people coming over in rafts across the border over to the U.S. side. This is actually happening right now. We just saw this. Cameraman Joshua Owen saw it over my shoulder as we were just reporting on Donald Trump coming in to talk about the unsecured border. This is breaking news. Right here, InfoWars catches it.
All right, I'm getting. Don't put your hand up.
We just caught these guys coming across the border. They're jumping in. They just jumped in rafts. They're coming over 1, 2, 3, 4. They have big satchels.
It's dramatic footage.
And they're driving away in this. That was a red Ford Explorer, right?
Yeah.
ABC News, none of them will cover this. Dramatic footage of them swimming across, loading up. Who knows what drugs were in there? If it was cocaine, then it's worth 10, 20, 30 million. If it was marijuana, maybe $1 million. Who knows? But looks like 8 or 9 satchels being loaded into their industrial level. And they're very precise. Looks like this is a regular event. A lot of times, if you don't just work for the drug cartels, they'll just kill you and your family. A lot of times, these guys aren't even paid. So that's what Donald Trump's talking about. And they act like none of this is going on or that it's racist, that we're worried about Mexico collapsing. What needs to stop is the phony drug war. It's what has put the money into this. Doesn't mean you legalize it. You just take the big money out of it. You decriminalize it. The drug war just gets worse and worse. But it was designed to do this. Joe Biggs, Josh Owens, you guys are going to be hosting to the bottom of the next hour together. More on this in Overdrive. Some stations do carry the fourth hour. But great job. You went down there for 24 hours and brought back the kill, brought back the intel.
Yeah, it was definitely an interesting trip. You know, we went down there expecting to cover the Donald Trump story and possibly try to get some questions in. You know, yesterday they came out saying that he was going to be down there. Then there were reports saying that he wasn't going to go. So what we wanted to do is we checked into a hotel. We're like, all right, let's just pull up a map. So I just pulled up my map app and just randomly dropped a pin on this stretch across the border on the Rio Grande. And it happened to be a spot that was just gold. We got out, we parked the vehicle. And as we were pulling up, actually, we actually had to do a U-turn and come back to the spot where we parked. We pulled up into a wooded area, but we passed 2 Border Patrol vehicles. So just remember that in the story, there's 2 Border Patrols right there in that area. So we pull in, park, hop out, and then we hear some balls bouncing. There's 2 kids bouncing one basketball, you know, back and forth. And the guy walks up behind our vehicle, and he's got his camera out, and he's doing this. Doesn't say anything, then walks away. So me and Josh were like, kind of look at each other like, that's a little odd. That's strange.
The cartels have intel databases.
Yeah. Well, they use spotters. They use kids. That's what they did in Afghanistan, Iraq. So that's not uncommon. So him and I walked down to the Rio Grande River and began to kind of go over some lines that we're going to talk about. And next thing you know, those kids come right back again. They walk out to the edge of the river right by us, and the kid's got his camera out, and he's pointing it right at me the whole time, taking pictures.
We have footage of this. I can't wait to see all the stuff.
Well, Josh was getting B-roll of the river at the same time, and I was kind of like, hey, these kids just came back, just kind of act normal.
See, I need to be able to send more guys with you. That's why we need to get more reporters, why we need more funding. We need a 3-man team. She can cover everything. Go ahead.
So, yeah, these kids walk away, and I look at him. I was like, this is just kind of odd. Don't you have a weird feeling about this? Like, let's just go ahead and film this just to get out of this area. So I start going over, you know, talking about Trump coming to the border, and over my right shoulder, Josh goes, oh, my God, look. And I turn around, and you see these, what is it, 7 people or
seven,
something?
8.
7 or 8 jump off the ravine into the Rio Grande and start swimming across the river on these floats with the big satchels in front of it. I mean, they're paddling for dear life to get over to that border. And I looked at him and I said, hey, we got to scurry up this embankment really quick. Let's get to the car, try to back out, and let's see where they're going to come out at.
And you did that. When we come back, we'll roll some of the footage in the background. If you're a radio listener, go to InfoWars.com, and you can find the free video feed at InfoWars.com/show. You can also find an article that has the video posted in it. Please send it to your friends and family. The traitor media, the occupier media doesn't want you to know. Come back in the next segment. I'm going to hit some on this. CDC suggests mothers delay breastfeeding to enhance vaccine. It says the new live virus vaccines they're giving, why the breast milk counters the virus. Oh, so they can't get a full brain damage. Oh, the mothers are fighting back, not even knowing it. That's the new CDC announcement. I mean, they'll probably ban breastfeeding next. And say, then it'll be a conspiracy it ever existed. And Salon can write articles about Alex Jones claims once there was breastfeeding. I mean, I'm not kidding. Oh, they have articles about how women are learning to pee standing up to battle men and have green underarm hair. I'm not joking. That's how you're free. You have green underarm hair. Women carry these little cups around so they can pee into urinals. That was in Yahoo News. I'm not joking. I meant to cover it yesterday.
Yeah, I saw that.
And I mean, it's just mental illness. While everything's collapsing, they literally have women turning their hair purple or pink under their arms, like I care. And you want to look like a sloth troll. And then you want to go in there and pee standing up. I mean, this is a joke.
Yeah, it looks like a cup mixed with a funnel.
These people are totally insane.
A vertical cup.
Meanwhile, the real women out there, it's like, don't give them the milk. It's liberal. Anyways, I'm sorry. Josh Owens, tell us about what you thought going down to the border.
Well, I think the big point is that we didn't go down there necessarily to film illegal immigrants coming across on the Rio Grande.
Illegal gods.
Illegal gods. I'm sorry. That was racist of me for saying immigrants. But so like Big said, he dropped a pin and we went to a location. Common sense says this happens all the time. Well, we know it happens all the time. But do you think that we just happened upon a place in the border and we see eight kids, you know, eight young men?
You did that like
men.
Gambling. It was like a spidey sense, didn't you?
Yeah, it just the force led me to that point. I mean, because we've been covering the border for over a year now, and not once have we ever gotten footage like that whatsoever. I mean, that...
Well, I mean, it's one thing to get people crossing, but up close, you're lucky you didn't get shot at.
Oh, that's what we're worried about. You know, those guys speeding away in that expedition more than likely have firearms in that vehicle, probably some AK-47.
But that's illegal.
But one of the interesting things was, though, is like I said, when we ran back to the vehicle, Josh jumped in the vehicle to drive and back out. As he was backing out, I got in the road to block traffic. When I looked to the right, those two Border Patrol trucks I told you about earlier were speeding off around the corner. As they sped off around the corner, the red SUV or the maroon-colored SUV, burgundy, whatever you want to call it, comes in, jumps back in, opens up, and they start loading those drugs into the back of that vehicle. So I've been watching these guys on the Border Patrol. A lot of their times, their shift change around 6 p.m., 6 a.m. This was close to 8 o'clock at night. And it was very weird for it to happen within seconds. They pulled off and were jetting around the corner. And at that exact same time, that drug deal happened right in front of us. We pulled into the spot where the Border Patrol vehicle was parked. That's where you got the footage of them actually loading.
So do you think they have people inside that knew when they were about to speed off? Or maybe they did a diversion down the road? Or are you saying maybe something else was going on?
I'm saying that it's possible that someone could get paid off to look the other way.
No, that's never happened. How unpatriotic of you. You mean our government could be corrupt too, like Mexico?
Yeah, well, you know.
Look, you heard me say that women used to give babies milk out of their mammary glands. A wild theory. Or that Margaret Sanger was a huge racist that wanted to kill black people. She only wrote, you know, books about it. And now he's claiming that we could have corruption in the government. Joe, next you're going to say the sky's blue and that fish swim in the ocean. Whoa, this guy's a kook. We're going to be right back. Overdrive, some stations carry it. Infowars.com/show. Support our local affiliates now. Support. So we make jokes about feminists trying to force men to pee sitting down, and then they want to pee standing up. It just shows the obsession with, like, mental illness. I mean, just insanity. While the whole world goes on around us and we're a planetoid in space, they're attacking the very species that we are. Meanwhile, you guys are down on the border, and there's just drugs being hauled right in front of you. Now you've got to give the license number that you got to the police. Other points you'd like to make? I know they came to your hotel, Josh.
Yeah, well, so we got back to upload this video, and I was upstairs, and I was on the phone at the time, and I had pushed the button to go down on the elevator. And as soon as the door opened, one of the two young men who was bouncing the basketball, who first came up to us when we were out there, was in the elevator. These kids live there. I mean, they're not tourists. It wasn't a tourist area. It wasn't an area anybody visits unless you're smuggling in drugs. And he was in the elevator. So he wasn't looking at me. He was looking out the backside of the elevator, almost like he was looking up and down to see if there was any, you know, trying to see if he noticed anybody on the levels. So I just immediately kind of darted over and went around the side, and he didn't see me. Then we go downstairs, and there's another guy who doesn't look like he fits in at the hotel. His shirt's a little dirty, just doesn't look like he's, you know, you notice when people aren't where they're supposed to be. He was staring at us while we were sitting downstairs. And I thought, well, maybe I'm just being a little bit paranoid because of what just happened. And, you know, the Los Zetas, the cartel that controls that area, they have been said that they're the most dangerous, most technologically advanced drug runners. So anyways, we go up to the room. Maybe 25 minutes later, the guy's gotten up. He's standing in front of my hotel room, leaning over the balcony on his phone, glancing up at me as I walk by. So I put my key in the door and he turns around and steps behind me. So my immediate reaction is I'm not going to open this door and come in here and let him come behind me and shut the door behind
me. I'm going to be honest. I would be close to decking him in the face at that point.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's just
good you guys got out of there. Please continue.
Well, so I turned around and I walked the other way. He kind of looked back at me and then he just kept walking the opposite direction. So at that point, we barricaded ourselves in our room because, you know, that's what we did. That seemed like the smart thing to do at the time.
And I bet you weren't armed. I bet you got in fetal positions.
I urinated on myself a little bit.
Did you do it sitting down? That's sexist.
I did it sitting down. I made sure I had to be
polite. Oh, well, thank God. Yeah, we did, though. No joke, though. I removed the license plate. We hid the vehicle. Yeah. I got under the vehicle because at one point we left the vehicle vulnerable when it was parked there when Josh and I were down there at the river. So I got on my hands and knees to look for any kind of tracking device.
But let me guess. I bet you had the HD 556 at the ready.
Oh.
No, we never do that. Anyway, so what happened next?
So, but just all in all, it was very strange. The fact that, you know, here we are. We go to this random spot. The Border Patrol's driving away. As this drug deal happens, we see the vehicle as it's driving away almost get T-boned by a semi-truck. We're in the middle of nowhere, really. You know, most of the trucks that are coming through are Border Patrol and or some semi-trucks that are transporting stuff. There's houses are a good bit ways away.
What did the Border Patrol think of you guys?
They didn't say anything. I mean, they probably thought we were part of the deal or something. They didn't have any clue because they just sat there. They watched us pull up. I even got to the back of the vehicle waiting on one of them to approach us because normally, whenever we go out there to the border, they'll come up and say, hey, what's going on? What are you guys doing out here?
Not these guys.
No, they just sat there. And then when we walked down to the embankment, those kids came by. Border Patrol jetted off, and then the drug deal happened. So, I mean, this was, like I said, one in a million. You never see something like this. Over the year that we've been covering this, I've been all the way from Brownsville all the way into California looking at the border, Arizona, all that. Never come across.
A lot of times they use tunnels under the Rio Grande.
This is a wide part in the river, too. This wasn't like in El Paso, where it's a lot more narrower,
walk across
shallower.
It.
Yeah, shallow. This was an actual wide, deep.
Well, let me just say this. You guys come back, cover it in detail from start to finish, all the facets of it, then bugging out of there. Great job. And you're going to be hosting the show. So great job, Joe Biggs. Great job, Josh Owens. I tell you, has it been an adventure since you've been here, guys?
To say the least.
Hey, I needed an adrenaline rush when I got out of the military, and this is definitely a. I definitely know short of that around here whatsoever.
The battle for the Republic right here in the homeland. Yeah,
there's still something going on.
Toe-to-toe with the New World Order. We'll be back. Stay with us.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm now your host, Joe Biggs, and I'm with me right now. We have Josh Owens, and we just recently got back from a trip to the border in Laredo, Texas, where we were planning to go and interview Donald Trump and kind of ask him about some of his different stances on immigration, veterans, things like that. But things didn't turn out that we wanted to, did it, Josh?
No, not at all. Not at all. And like I said earlier, we didn't go down there necessarily to capture illegals coming across the border. We especially, because like Big said, we've been along the border through Arizona, California, Texas. So we've seen a lot, but we haven't seen anything quite like this. And we really weren't expecting it. But just to start over to explain what we were doing, we went out there to talk about Trump because Trump has brought, you know, kind of shined light once again on the border while running for president. So we went out there to get a couple questions with him, interview him because he was out there doing his presidential PR. Biggs dropped the pin on his iPhone so we could find a place along the border, just a scenic area where we could shoot a quick report that night leading up to the next day, which would have been this morning. And so we went to this area. It was pretty desolate. There were two Border Patrol cars not far from where we were. Like Biggs said, we actually had to loop around to come back and find a little dirt road to pull into. It was almost like a trail. So we pull in and all of a sudden we hear a bouncing basketball. Which was strange because there were no kids around. There were no houses. There weren't people around there. It wasn't an area where there were people hanging out. It was a road. There was no sidewalk. There was nowhere for these kids to be. There was a road. So we heard the bouncing basketball.
But we didn't even see them walking by as we drove up to that area. So did someone drop them off? I mean, that's like you said, there's no houses for them to walk to. That's not a normal area for two young teenage boys to just be walking around in the middle of the day like that. I mean, that's super shady.
So we heard them. We heard the sound of a basketball, which was odd. And then all of a sudden, I was getting the stuff out of the car, and then I saw these two young men. These two young men were coming behind the car, and they stopped and they looked at us strangely. And then all of a sudden, they just turned around. So it was like they were walking in one direction, and then they just turned back around the other way because they saw us. The whole reason they were there, which we ultimately found out, was to scout out the area. Because these people were about to come over with a large amount of drugs. And I'm talking what would have amounted to millions of dollars of drugs, depending on what the drug was. And we know that the Las Zetas are, especially in that area, they is one of the biggest cocaine trafficking areas. So at the time, they're two younger kids. You're not going to think, oh, these guys are a lookout for the cartel, for the Las Zetas. That's not what we were thinking. We were thinking these are just kids. Maybe we should lock the door because they may, you know, mess with our stuff. So we see that the Rio Grande is right next to, right across this little trail is right next to us where we were parked. So we go down there to shoot a report, yada, 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 yada. We shot the whole report. And then all of a sudden behind me, the kids come down and are taking photos of us. And at the time I'm shooting B-roll, so I don't even see the kids. And Biggs is like, hey, look up there. You know, they're taking pictures of us. I turn around and they just kind of walk past us, you know, kind of smile.
Nonchalantly.
Yeah, and walk past us. Even then, I was like, well, these kids, you know, they're interested because we have cameras.
We were kind of complacent, though. I mean, as many times as we've been to the border, we should have known a little bit better. We were just expecting to go there for the whole Trump interview, and then we kind of get down there and get thrown into the situation. Not many people really ever get to encounter when they're out there. I mean, like you said, over a year, I've never come across that before yet. We've seen people passing over the border. We've shown how easy it is to cross the border. And yet you got these Democrats saying, oh, the borders are secure. There's fine. There's nothing going on whatsoever. But we keep seeing it. We keep showing it. Every time we go down there, it gets crazier and crazier.
Yeah, it plays into a lot of the hearts and minds. It's like, well, these people, you know, they're you know, they have to come across the border because they can't live over there. They have to come across the border. And the point that we make is that look at the type of people that are coming across the border. One thing that I personally, just to give my personal opinion, I don't necessarily agree with Trump when he says that the majority of them are rapists or murderers, and some of them,
yeah, small majority,
you would assume, yeah, are good people. I don't necessarily agree with that, but we do know that there are rapists and murderers on both sides of the fence, but that those are the ones that a lot of them have been caught coming across the border, and they found prayer rugs. So it's not just people from Mexico.
Other than Mexicans.
Yeah, other than Mexicans. Prayer rugs, Korans. Joe Biggs dressed up as an ISIS jihadi and walked across the border. So we know that whether it's happened or not, and we know it's happened, we know that they've set up camps across the border. I mean,
we've seen them bring illegals into Lackland Air Force Base in San Antonio, housing them there, not going through proper procedures to screen these children as whether or not they have any kind of viruses, illnesses whatsoever. And meanwhile, they're camped right next door to soldiers or airmen going through AIT, which is advanced individual training, to learn their MOS in the Air Force. Now, if you're a parent, do you want someone like that who's not documented, who hasn't had, you know, the proper checkups to be around your soldier when they're supposed to be there under, you know, the watch of these supervisors, and they're just being allowed to sit there and bake out in the sun for days on end? God knows what they have.
Exactly. But once again, the soldiers are not the top priority.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they don't care anything about soldiers, just like the fact that the attack at Chattanooga, the fact that these soldiers aren't allowed to arm themselves whatsoever. And meanwhile, you get patriots across the country flood out to these recruiting centers by the hundreds. And they set up posts. They sit out there. I myself spent 3 days, 2.5 days actually, guarding the one in South Austin. And now the Department of the Army has the gall to come out and say that we're a security threat? Come on. What kind of country do we live in when our government fails and we can't stand up to help protect the soldiers who go overseas to fight and die for the freedoms, the right for you to complain, the right for you to be whatever it is you want to be, and we can't let citizens come out there and help out a little bit? It's kind of pathetic that we actually have to have citizens come out there and do that anyways. The government should already go ahead and pass this so these guys can sit there. And to sit there every day for the, you know, for the 2.5 days I was there, to watch the wives of those airmen, Marines, soldiers come up and say thank you. My kids, thank you, because I'm going to get to see my husband another day, because they are scared that another attack like Chattanooga can happen again. And you've got these bureaucrats at the Pentagon, you've got these higher ups who could care less. You know, they have our military marching around in high heels. It's ridiculous. We look like a joke to ISIS. The reason that I just can't believe that we've turned our military and the American pride that we used to have in this country, we look like a soft target.
Yeah, and I think with what I got of what you were saying is the worst, or not the worst, but you know, a horrible thing about what you're saying is that it's the veterans and their families that are having to, you know, carry this burden. You know, every single day it affects their lives. You know, I was never in the service. I wasn't in the military. I have some family that was, but it's not a thought that's on my mind every day. It crosses my mind occasionally when I see it in the news and I hear, you know, when I talk to some friends, but it's not something that controls my life, controls my thoughts. And you have to think, the veterans and their families, their wives, their kids, it's something that affects them every second of every day.
Well, because most of their husbands have been in the military for 20 plus years. Once they get to that recruiting position, a lot of times they've already been deployed. So they've had to worry about whether or not their husband's going to come back home, whether or not their husband's going to see their kids again, whether or not their kids are going to grow up without a father, and then to have them come back and get a pretty chillax job like a recruiter, which is one of the jobs I wish I could always got just to take a break for a little bit from everything, and to have to worry about whether or not your husband or wife's going to come back from just going out and recruiting or sitting in the office talking to people, talking to recruits, and getting shot up.
That should be the time where they are at ease, when their fathers, their mothers, their husbands, their wives are back home and not overseas. Yet now they can't. That can't even be a time now where they can, you know, have that comfort.
My father was in the Marine Corps. My best friend that I've had since I was about 4 or 5, I consider him a brother. I've called him a brother my entire life. He calls me a brother. He was a devil dog. And to sit there and tell these guys they can't wear their own uniform when they go into their jobs as a recruiter, I mean, that's a punch in the face. That's like telling me I can't wave an American flag. I am an American. I am very proud of what I've done for my country. I love my country. I will give my life for my country, and I will give my life for those around me in support of those freedoms. And when you strip a uniform from a Marine, when you tell them they can't do that, that is the most degrading thing you could ever do. You know, I mean, no wonder ISIS sits there and goes, yeah, this is an easy target. I mean, it's out of control. And there's just so many crazy things going on. I mean, every time we come in here and we look at these different articles every day, it's almost like we live in this time warp that it seems like a futuristic movie.
Yeah, and one thing that I've noticed on recent trips, it seems like now almost every trip that I go on, something happens to reinforce what's going on in these articles. Something happens to, you know, because sometimes people, they get complacent and they think, well, it's just the news. They're hyping stuff up. This isn't really going on. Donald Trump is just trying to, you know, he's finding this segment of people that has a belief and he's just reinforcing it to get votes. And then we show up and then we see people smuggling in drugs. And, you know, regardless of the discussion of whether drugs should be legalized or not, the fact of the matter is that illegal immigrants are crossing over an open border, bringing drugs into the United States. Yet we're bad if we talk about it.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm truly shocked that no one's picked up this video. I guess my naivety, I thought this morning it would be everywhere, because I honestly believe if any other news outlet would have picked this up, it would be circulated in the news. This would be a much bigger story.
They showed video footage down in on the Mexico border where they were riding Sea-Doos around. But you didn't see something like this, paddling across with drugs, going up an embankment, and then making that. I mean, we had awesome footage from right across the street. You don't get to see that every day. And a lot of people question what's going on. So we'll be back here in just a little bit with the Alex Jones Show. Coming out of the break, we'll be back. We'll talk about some more topics. Thank you.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm your host, Joe Biggs, with Joshua Owens. Now we're going to get back into the story you were talking about, Josh.
Right. So just to preface, at this point, we're not there looking for immigrants crossing the border. We're there to shoot a quick report about Trump being in Laredo, Texas. So these two kids, which at the time we didn't realize were spotters, have taken photos of us, have gotten our license plate number, have, and now they're kind of off on the side. I mean, I guess, I don't know if they left. I don't know where they went. They just disappeared off into the bushes.
Well, they're probably trying to see if we were a threat or not.
Right. So, behind Biggs, after all this has taken place, when it finally clicks what those kids are doing there, I see seven or eight young men jump into the Rio Grande. And this, like he said, when he crossed the border in El Paso, the Rio Grande is
much shallower.
Very shallow. This is very, very deep. So as you can see in this video, they're crossing over. And I don't know if they have, at the time, I think we thought they had rafts, but I think they were balancing on these boxes of drugs.
Yeah, it was kind of hard to tell from that far back.
Yeah, well, because honestly, and this is the one thing I haven't talked about yet. When we got this footage, just as you hear Big saying earlier in the video, you can see this video on Infowars.com and on the Alex Jones channel on YouTube. Big says this is breaking news. We got to go get this up. So we run up to the car to get this up. Biggs blocks the road, although there is no traffic. There's no one coming. He's just making sure no one's
because
coming.
Because we had trees on both sides. You couldn't see anything.
Yeah. This is the only vehicle, as you can see in this video, this is the only vehicle that drove by other than this red Expedition, this burgundy Expedition, while we were sitting there. So we toyed with the idea of walking down the trail and getting close-up footage of what we thought, or what I thought, was a family.
Well, I just thought it was people going to come over with some clothes. When they first started hopping over that rail, I thought they had a raft because I thought they had deflated the raft. And then once I started looking, those were drugs.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the same stuff you see on Breaking Bad or when you're watching some kind of a show like that with the Border Patrol out there.
Exactly. So we kind of mutually decided not to go down this trail.
Thank God.
Thank God we did, because who knows what could have happened. We could have been murdered, you know, and in that moment, I thought back after we saw the drugs, as soon as we were leaving, I thought back to the time when we were in El Paso. We drove out. I can't remember the name of the mountain, but we drove out about an hour and a half outside of El Paso.
Yeah, that's when we're looking for those ISIS spotters.
Where there were apparent ISIS spotters watching the border so that people could come over with drugs.
Yeah.
We were an hour and a half from anything. We were in the middle of nowhere. We had no cell service. There was the last Border Patrol agent we saw, as we noticed this time, it's not like it would have mattered. It's not like they would have helped.
Yeah.
Was maybe 20 minutes back.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Because we had to go down that long, winding dirt road where there was just zero chance of getting any help whatsoever.
And in that moment, I thought, if this would have taken place there, there's a very good possibility we would be dead.
Especially with the truck that was picking up the drugs. Because you know those guys are going to be armed. They're going to have some kind of AK-47. Because there's probably going to be other rival gangs, you know, whatever have you, on that side of the border, on our side, and those guys would be armed to the teeth. If we would approach something like that, forget about it. I mean, luckily, we didn't make that decision.
And that's one of the things that I want to say to these morons who comment on these videos and say that we've made this up and that this isn't real. The stuff that we're doing is real. We're putting ourselves in danger to get this information out, which a lot of mainstream media doesn't do. Some of them do. I'm not saying they all don't, but a lot of them don't. So when people see, I think that's the issue. I think when people see real stuff like this, they think, oh, it has to be fake. There's no way it can.
I mean, there's a good chance that I myself, when crossing over the border, dressed up like a jihadi, holding a severed head and a sword, that a Border Patrol agent could have just easily driven down that road at that exact time that we decided to pull that stunt. I could be dead right now.
And if you'll remember, just to give people a little behind the scenes, we were kind of freaked out. We were like, this is a big deal.
I mean, I felt nervous at my stomach. I mean, my stomach was knotted up. We were going back and forth. Should we do it? Should we not do it? Is this worth dying over? You know, and the same thing when we went to Mexico the last time, when I crossed over to the border to go look for that ISIS base. I mean, my stomach was in knots. But once I got over there and I could kind of get in that combat mode, I felt relaxed in that situation. But it was a different nervous this time around, because when you're driving, when I was going through Annapurna, I saw some spotters here and there, but I didn't know what anyone's intentions were. You knew what these guys' intentions were. Their intentions were to get those drugs over the border, regardless of what's going on. They didn't care. I mean, you can see the one guy that's loading up the back of the vehicle, holding the door up. He looks back and sees us. So you know those guys in that red Expedition saw us as well.
Well, thank you for watching the Alex Jones Show and listening as well. Make sure you tune in tonight for the InfoWars Nightly News, 7 p.m. Central. I'm your host, Joe Biggs.